too soon, but you know, we're gonna do it. It's fine. Hopefully you can hear me okay. We are gonna do a quick cooking stream. Well, probably baking. Maybe cooking, we'll see. But I hope you're all doing well. Like I said, I pressed the button a little too quick, so we're gonna keep setting things up. Echo? Shuffle Twitch-friendly grooves.
Twitch-friendly grooves from Spotify.
Story, I'ma tell them that. They wanna see I got the visions, want the change, I'll make the difference. And you know that I'll be searching till I bring it back. Yeah, I went through hell and back to find myself, but I am not the same as who I left. No, I am not the same, I'm being better from the head. So still I'm on that same mode. Still I'm gonna need to reach the payroll. Since I was like 8 times 8, oh, I was always thinking you was feeding up the tables. I ain't really know, but I should though. I ain't really get it, but I'm quick though. Something about the distance got me shook though. That's so full of I don't cares and I don't know. But I've been hiding from the part of me, so keep it close. My time fits my normal face, so you know that ain't changed. I gotta go, I gotta check, so you know I can't stay. Yeah, you know I can't stay. And I see the sun, it sets down on my tired city. Wind blowing on my face, I wonder if it's drifting to somewhere far away. I like to come along it, I like to come along it. Oh, I like to come along it. I see the sun, it sets down on my tired city. Wind blowing on my face, I wonder if it's drifting.
Morning, or evening, happy time zone. How's it going, Anon? Welcome in. My hair looks crazy, but it's because I curled it and then I tried to put it up so it'd still look good. Cosmic Nova! I'm having such a good day. I hope you are.
I could have just asked her to turn herself down.
I'm so glad that you stopped in. Thanks for being here. Anon, I'm glad you're here. Look at you. I didn't even post it on Discord. You're already in here. It's been a super good day, so Elon woke up in like a really good mood. He like started burying me with pillows. Oh, thank you. He buried me with a bunch of pillows, and then I was like, okay, we'll get up. So I get up, we did French toast for breakfast, and I have this amazing bread that I used, and he loved it. We go to Aldi, and so I got this from Aldi. Chocolate chip brioche. The sticker's like right in the middle of the word, but oh my goodness. It's like buttery and delicious. It's like pastry bread. It's so good. And so this like dipped in, I did an egg and then oat milk and cinnamon, vanilla, pumpkin pie spice, I think I did. So good. I almost did that on stream and then I was like, this is gonna take me 5 minutes. So I was like, that's silly. So today I'm trying to figure out what to make, honestly. I was gonna put, I'm thinking this is what I'm probably gonna do. I've done buckeyes on stream. Calm down, phone, chill out. And so I wanna do these buckeye cookies, which are like chocolate. It's like a sugar cookie with cocoa powder in it, right? And then on the inside is peanut butter mixed with powdered sugar. So it's like a buckeye with a cookie, and you like freeze the first part, or refrigerate maybe. Nope, you freeze them. Freeze the first part for 30 minutes. Hi, Dr. Oko, glad to see you. Right? Oh my god, they look so good. Oh, thanks, Spirit. I curled it and then I was like, I want to put it up and like hopefully when I take it down it still is going to look good because I like did a clip and then pinned the back of it up with a bow. Right? Holding it together. We're keeping it together, people. And I didn't even realize the bow was the same color velvet as the sweater I just got. I was like, dang. Oh, shoot. Thanks, girl. Oh, thanks, you. Thank you, spirit. Brain. Yes, I'm on it. Thank you. I meant to do that, too, ahead of time. But what it was I pressed the button too soon when I went live. I was like, oops. But that happens pretty much like 80% of the time when I go live. It's like I'm going to put my phone in the clip just to like see how I look and how everything's looking. Yeah. I'm like, okay, go live. And then I can like see everything, but I don't click start stream yet. I can just like barely see myself. So I'm like, do I look okay? Like, how's stream look? So silly, but so true. All right, stream manager, edit, stream, fitness and health. Let's get to the food and drink category. We are not doing afternoon qigong, though we could. I actually started, when I used to do Sunday afternoon classes with my paradigm shift group, I have this qigong teacher named Sifu Boggy from the UK, and he's just a wonderful being. He's such a good guy, and he would teach qigongs on Sunday afternoons, and for whatever reason, I would just always do it out here in my kitchen. Like, I'd be, like, making tea and lunch or something and, like, doing qigong out here with them, so. The I Love Lucy thing going. Oh my god, I love that. Okay, what are we titling this? Bacon. I don't know. What are we saying? What's cooking good looking? Is that too cliche? Man, you can tag ADHD? That is a good thing to tag for me. Will you be on track? No. Good to know. Chatty, probably also accurate. This is so good. I love this. Mental health. She, her. Bam. Well, bam. Can I do any others? So good. Cozy. These are all good things. I can only do 5? Oh man. Okay, I'll take off that one. Is that 5? I did way too many tags. Who let me do all those tags? Do I know how to do an I Love Lucy impression? I do, but I don't really want to do it on stream. It's been a long time since I've seen I Love Lucy, actually. Oh my god. I just remember, this one episode where she's working in the factory, and, and she's doing fine, she's doing great, she's going along, she's doing her job, and then, like, all of a sudden, the conveyor belt starts speeding up, and, like, everything gets out of hand, and, like, everything starts going all nuts. Oh my god. It's been literally probably since I was, like, a kid when I used to watch TV Land. Anybody else? Old school TV? All the time. I grew up on The Cosby Show and The Brady Bunch. And, like, so I only watched a couple episodes of I Love Lucy. I was more into, oh my gosh, what else did I love? I'm trying to remember now. There were so many good ones. We'll take this off. Okay, let's see. Cozy, chatty, ADHD, woman, mental health. That's 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Oh, I see. They already put creative and IRL. Okay. Okay, did that update? Let's see. Hopefully. That. Oh, shoot. So close. So close, y'all. What just happened? Golden Girls. I love Golden Girls, but I actually only saw Golden Girls for the first time. I can't believe Ben just raided me. Hello, Ben. Hi, chat. Hi. I so glad you're all here. Welcome in, my loves. Aw, hi. I was just chatting in your chat. I, like, ran into my room to, like, chat, and then I heard you say, like, go for walks after stream. I was like, that's so cute. Aw. I was just like, I should do that. That's such a good idea. Like, I love being inspired by other streamers. Lisa, hi. I'm wondering how short you are, and I feel like I probably asked you this already. And then I'm like, that's so silly. And I have to retype my whole stream because I messed it up. I forgot to, it didn't save. So, fixing that really quick, but I'm so glad you're all in here. I was like, oh no, I'm like in the middle of fixing my stream. Ooh. Do you hear that? They're like, hey, enjoy your weekend. It's a little celebration. Wow, I'm so glad you're in here. We are gonna cook. We're gonna make something delicious. I'm feeling the buckeye cookies, which I know we were just looking. I just posted the red velvet cookies from this cookbook in Ben's Discord. If you're not in Benetron's Discord, get in there. Oh, you subscribed, now you can use the emotes. Enjoy the emotes, the little cutie redheads. I bought those actually from an artist on Etsy. So yay for supporting local artists. Thank you for subscribing. I appreciate you, Lisa. I'm glad you're in here. I love when people ask me that. I'm actually not as short as people think. I'm 5'5". Oh, that's hilarious. I love that. I was like, I bet people ask that all the time. I'm like, I'm not gonna ask it. And then I just did, inadvertently, in a roundabout way. Yeah, I always do my ooh-woo face and Ben's ooh-woo face. Looking at each other, it's just like perfect. It's like they're made to be together. Those emotes. So last time I did a cooking stream, I did buckeyes. So it was like peanut butter, powdered sugar, mixed together, dipped in melted chocolate. So delicious. So these are buckeye cookies. So it's like chocolate sugar cookies with peanut butter powdered sugar in the middle that you freeze, and then you bake them together. Like, you wrap the cookie around the powdered sugar peanut butter ball, and then you bake them, and they like melt together. 5'5" buds. Oh, nice, y'all. I am 5'2". I'm pretty short. But I grew up really fast, so I was like one of the tall kids in like fourth grade, and then like I didn't grow much after that. Like, legitimately. I'm still wearing, like, I can still wear kids' clothes. Thank you. Look at that cat dance. Cat jam jam. Cat jam jam. I'm feeling so hyper today. I, like, didn't sleep a lot and was gonna nap today, and then I was like, if I don't stream, it's gonna be too late, and then I'm not gonna stream, and then I'm just gonna keep watching other people stream. Which is pretty much what I've done all day. And it's silly because it's a beautiful blue sky out today, and I just realized I haven't been outside. And I'm like, Carly. But tomorrow. I'll go out tomorrow. I'll go get some fresh air. Maybe I'll go for an evening walk, too. The cutest. That's so... Okay, so my name on, like, Instagram and everything used to be Carly the Cute. And, like... It's just like my claim to fame, like being small and cute. And then everyone's like, no, it's got you forgot the ST at the end of your name. So then I changed it to Carly the Cutest. And then I was just like, oh, I'm being too egotistical. Dang it, did I not save that yet? What's cooking? Good looking, food and drink. Add tags. Okay. Thanks. Again. Again, again, again. Simple loving holy. It is so silly. Done. Update information. That's the button I needed to press. Now did it work? Did it work? No, it still says afternoon qigong there, doesn't it? Update. Did it work? Successfully updated, it says. Yeah? Did it work? Oh my gosh, that's so great, because I'm like, because I worry, because people come in here after a raid, you know, and like 10 people leave immediately, and you're just like, oh no, you're just like, I'm just gonna crawl in my hole, like, nobody likes me. You're just like this mindset of just like, awkward being. Hi, Budman. Hello. I did it. There's a celebratory emote in the chat, so I must have done a thing. I did a good thing. I am very easily distracted. I'm usually distracting myself. Like, people are like, I'll sit and wait for people forever, like, because it doesn't bother me. I'm like, I could entertain myself doing whatever, so. So silly. I'm silly like that. So then I could distract myself as well when I need to do something for real. Two adorable onesies. Yes, I have a twosies. Being wacky is where it's at. Love it. Hadn't even been in one of her streams and was like, yep, she's awesome. Oh my god, because I say some ridiculous things in chats. The unicorn one. Oh my god. That one's legitimately a kid's one too. That was in the children's section and I was like, I could fit this. And my mom's like, definitely. I was like, should I buy this? This is kind of, she's like, you're buying it. And then I was like, look, I bought it. And I was like, first of all, there's no pockets. So I'm going to put pockets on it. And there's no tail. So I have to add a rainbow, glittery rainbow tail, I think. Yep. That emote spirit. Exactly. Precisely. Wow, I'm so excited. All right, y'all. So let's get to cooking. Sorry about that. Loud noises. Loud noises! It's the ears on the Snoopy one, though. I know, right? Those little bunny ears. And one is, like, slightly less stuffing than the other one. I love that there's always something off about that stuff. We all need some cute onesies. Exactly. Yeah, see? I never need the correction. My uncle? You should see how my uncle from Oklahoma texts. It's, like, in Morse code half the time. Half the time, it's, like, literally not words. It's like random letters put together into a half-formed thought. And my mom's like, hands me the phone and she's like, figure this out. And I'm like, oh, he's talking about odd. Oh, like one time he texted her like this random sentence and I was like, oh, he's talking about some song and this reference here. And I was like, oh, and like, are your parents have some party coming up? And she's like, oh yeah, that's right. We're supposed to do this and that. And I was like, yeah, that's what he's trying to say. She's like, how did you figure that out from like, it was like H-O-9-E, you know, like, hope y'all are having a good day. But like, he'd get so many typos in there, you literally couldn't read it. And I was just like, instantly could detect it. I was like, don't even worry. I was like, this is like bad handwriting, but like the text version of bad handwriting. And, I am, also, not a teacher, but, like, a teacher assistant and, like, a, spiritual, I guess I was a teacher, I was a spiritual, youth mentor, that's what they called me, that was my title. And so, like, I have been reading bad handwriting forever, like, it does not bother, I was a kindergarten mentor, like, like, you cannot confuse me, pretty much. I'm like that. I pride myself in that. Trying to, like, just being able to, like, figure out or know what people are saying before they say it. So, I got an amazing surprise. Hello, Heretic! What's good, homie? How's it going? Oh my god, I'm so glad you're all in here. What a great day this is. And look, we're streaming in the afternoon. We get a weekend to ourselves. I'm not ignoring my son right now. It's amazing. I feel so great. That moment when you remove Carly as a VIP in your stream. What happened? What'd you do? Did you make me a mod? I accept modhood. Spirit doing the dance. Party! I feel like that's the Egyptian dance that we all did, but like, why? What? Why? Where did that come from? Why did we think that? Such a weird thing. Ah! Oh my gosh! Hi, Robin. Hello. Oh my gosh, Ben, my heart is so full right now. Thank you so much. I always feel like I'm being knighted when I become a mod. I'm like, oh yes, I will willingly bow. Please place the sword on both of my shoulders. I accept. I am honored, honestly. It's official. It's official. I joined the mod squad. Mod squad. What are you doing, Robin? My favorite redhead is on. Oh yeah, that's me. And a gong in the 80s. What? Normally, like, I just talk about how well I am at how well I am at figuring things out, and then I instantly can't. Oh my god, that's hilarious. Another partner in crime. What are we doing? What is our next crime? What crime are we committing? Come on now, Ben. Why do you gotta do Carly like that and remove her as a VIP? He brought me up to mod god status. Okay, this has totally gotta be in my playlist that's called Uplifting Beats. I'm feeling happy, positive vibes today since I woke up. Oh, is that, yeah, that's totally how I'm feeling too. It's like, last night I had a really great conversation with a friend who like, I was like, is this loud? Am I yelling? I don't know. Woman taking over the manpower. What do we, wait, what? I'm feeling, yes. Okay, so I had a great conversation. One of my friends that I met him apparently in like 2015 or 2016 at this local music festival. We just have like a bunch of mutual friends and we're all like hanging out. He's got a son who's 8 now. So I probably met him when his son was probably about Elon's age, 3 or 4. But super, like, just a nice guy, and he was like, oh, I'm just having a rough day. He's like, you want to chat? I was like, sure, like, Elon's asleep, like, I'm done streaming, you know, done hanging out in Cosmic Stream, so it's like midnight, and we just ended up chatting about, like, random stuff. He was, like, complaining about this guy who's living with them, and I just needed to vent sometimes, and I was, like, just kept bringing it back to the positive and being like, well, it sounds like you're upset that he's not contributing enough to, like, he's like living at your house and not contributing enough to meals. I'm like, so maybe you just need to set up a meal plan or like have that open communication about like, hey, this is the schedule I need to make this like a reasonable situation for you to be living here for free. And I was like, you know, like if you're feeling like, oh my god, it's Practical Magic is in the house, what's good, Lisa, great to see you, hey buddy. I know, that's why it's so cute. Panthos, glad to see you too. Hello, hello. Audio sounds fine. Good deal, good deal. Ooh, seniority. Great, Ben. Or Ben, Bud Man, we're proud of you. Mrs. High Roland, usually need meds to help, but I haven't been able to get them yet today. So that's a little refreshing. Then I get a notification that you're on, and I'm like, what? Yes. Love it, dude. Love it. Yeah, I like, honestly, I woke up this morning feeling good. Elon was being silly. Made breakfast, made brioche chocolate. I have this chocolate chip brioche bread from Aldi. Fire. Look at this. Look at this. Highly recommend. If you want to get yourself a treat and just like have like a slice of this in the morning for breakfast with like a cup of tea or like hot cocoa or coffee. Chocolate chip brioche. Look at this. From Aldi, so it's that specialty select brand. This is like $3.99 a loaf or something. So yummy, sweet, buttery, delicious. Like if you're craving chocolate and you're like, I don't want to eat too much chocolate. Oh, so good. So we made French toast out of this. It was awesome. We do like peanut butter on top of our French toast, which I know a lot of people are like, what? But I've always done peanut butter on top of pancakes and French toast. It's just like that extra, like extra protein, like a little bit of savory, like saltiness with the sweet. Oh, so good. This song is killer too. We're all equal. Exactly, we're all equal. I like your sign. That is a good sign. This is a good sign. It's a good sign that it's a good sign. I love the one next to it. This is my personal favorite in the whole kitchen. The little Buddha plaque. Love this. We've found some of the greatest things at like thrift stores and secondhand stores. Like just some of the coolest stuff. So how is everyone today? How's everyone's evening? Ooh, peanut butter, half Nutella. Used to be my cheat combo. Oh my god, yeah. That's like my go-to, like, craving. Little couple spoonfuls of that when you're really craving chocolate. Grilled PB&J, that's my go-to. That's my go-to, like, lazy meal. Elon won't eat anything else. Like, he's literally just... won't try anything that I'm making. Snickers sandwich, yum. Actually, hang on. I like that name. I want to open like an all-night diner that's like healthy comfort food. So I have like journals full of recipes that I want to do. I make this thing that I've made for my family since I was a kid that I call Christmas in a cup. And it's like hot cocoa with like extra spices and like just like little hidden things that like one of my siblings loved, oh my gosh, I'm totally blanking right now. He loved caramel, so I would do, like, a drizzle of caramel in his, or, like, my sister loves, spice, so I would do cayenne peppers in hers and make hers, like, a Mexican hot chocolate, but, like, I always add, like, I'm like, I can't tell you my secret ingredient. Okay, I will. It's nutmeg. Add nutmeg to your hot cocoa and it just like takes it to a whole nother level. Like it just makes it literally like Christmas in a cup. Like so unbelievable. So I usually do that with like a little bit of like alternative milk or I love topping it with whipped cream personally. But like so comfort foods, comfort drinks, just like cozy things where you just feel like so grilled peanut butter and jelly. Grilled Nutella and peanut butter though and just call it a Snickers sandwich. Like oh my god, you could even do like a banana cream, like a Boston cream or something, and do like sliced bananas and peanut butter, or like call it an Elvis and do like, because Elvis is always like peanut butter and chocolate and bananas for some reason, so like, or maybe do like bananas, peanut butter, and Nutella and call it like a monkey's uncle, right? Because you got the bananas and like, oh my god, that'd be so good. Okay, but seriously, I'm gonna stop having fun with empty threats. Y'all are just going back and forth. I'm not even reading chat. I love you. And they tell me every day how they wish I wasn't allergic to bananas so they could have banana bread. Aww. That's sad. I'm looking at bananas that I just have ready to make banana bread, actually. I should probably make that. Your threats do not sway me. Dang, you can't have banana bread. You can do zucchini bread, though. Zucchini bread's, like, another level. Zucchini bread's way better than banana bread. Banana bread is, like, zucchini bread's, like, you know, less... Zucchini is, like, the cousin of banana bread that comes to visit in the summer. Right? That's what zucchini bread is. Zucchini bread is banana bread's hot cousin that comes to visit in the summer when everyone's garden has way too much zucchini bread. You're like, sheesh. Zucchini bread, you're looking good over there. Are you single? You want to go to the pool later? I love y'all. Zucchini bread is top tier, for sure. Every time I eat zucchini bread, I'm like, why do I even mess around with banana bread? Is zucchini bread single? That was a really silly quote. I hope someone clipped that. I was like, I'm just gonna pause, just gonna let that one sink in. I'm gonna hope that somebody clipped me. I'm gonna clip myself later. Give myself a little break. I'll know exactly when that was. If you guys have, I think I've been in If you guys stream, I think I've been in all of your streams, or I try to. If you guys stream, let us know. Tell everyone. This is what we need to do. I had Raina the other day. She was like, listen, like, if you're a streamer, put out there, tell us what your vibe is. Like, tell us what you do on stream, and like, get, you know, we are all about genuine connections. Like, if you have, you know, great content you're putting out there, and you have, and there's somebody in the chat who connects with it and is like, I totally want to vibe with you, I want to see you stream, like, shoot, let's get in there, you know, like, let's support each other. I've not streamed for a year and a half now.
Dang, Lisa.
Sometimes it's just like, you're not feeling it. Zucchini bread is sexy for sure. Melt in your mouth goodness. Zucchini bread sounds hot. Zucchini bread is hot. Zucchini bread, you know, dang. I haven't streamed for 2 months now. I know, I was just gonna say that. I was like, it's been a while since I've seen you stream. But like, this has been kind of an off, like, summer season. I was gonna say winter. Just gonna fix my shirt up here. This is what I get so into some of these songs. Alright, so, unless you guys have another idea, because like I said, this is always my problem, is I want to make something out of here, and then I'm like, there's so many good things to make in here. Okay, this one's crazy. Hot Cheetos macaroons. Hot Cheetos, y'all. Crazy. Not my thing. Haven't streamed for 20 minutes now. Ugh, we all miss it so much. We miss you already, Benetron. Like, genuinely, I'm, like, so excited every time. I'm like, it's 1:30, is Benetron on? And then I go on there, and I'm like, oh, it's not on. What's going on? Let's check your schedule. Oh, tomorrow? Loving you. Oh. Oh. So lovely loving you. Whoa. Whoa. It's like I hit affiliate 2019, broke for about a year, streamed twice in 2020, then left again. You're like, meh, Twitch, meh. Yeah. Weekends without a Benetron is never fun. I know. My heart. I like, and then I see him playing Isaac, and I'm like, I like literally want to call you on Discord and be like, can I watch you play Isaac? Is there a way for me to do this? Can you stream just to me? If you're not going to stream to everyone, can I watch you play Isaac? But for you, when you love me, it's so lovely loving you. Whoa. 5'2", so lovely loving you. Whoa. I'm very short. I'm shorter than my lamp, right? Give you all my time. Oh, so tiny. You're so tiny. I'm like 100 pounds, yeah. I'm very tiny. A foot taller. Oh, a foot taller than me. It's my favorite phrase to hear in the whole world. Oh my god, that's so cute. Yeah, I love that. Oh, damn. I was gonna guess 5'7". I'm glad I didn't guess. Yeah, I know. I tell people this. I'm like, I have tall energy. Like, people, I didn't find out how short I was, or that I was short, until, so I'm in high school. I'm about to graduate. This is like a month before we all graduated. I'm standing there with one of my oldest friends. Literally, him and my mom went to church together before we were both born. So this is how, like, most of me and my childhood friends met. And then my mom was in this mom's group with all these, like, kids that were my age. So we all grew up together, like, going to the, like, playground together and, like, doing all these, like, random things. Having New Year's Eve parties every night together, or every year together. And so one of my friends... He's tall. He's so tall. His parents are ridiculously tall. His mom is probably, like, close to 6 foot, and his dad is, like,
closer to 7 foot, I think, than 6 foot. Like, they're such tall people. And I look up at him one day, he's like over 6 foot, easy. He's probably 6'5", maybe taller. And I look up at him one day, and I'm just like, oh, Marshall, you are so tall. And he's like, I'm not really that tall, Carly, you're just really short. And I was like, and I look around at all my friends, you know, look around at all my friends, and I'm like, shoot, am I the short one here? And I look around, there's no one my height. I'm like, oh my god, y'all, you guys, why didn't you tell me I was short? Nobody told me I was short until now. They're like, we thought you knew. Like, we didn't think that was something we had to tell you at 18 years old. You're like about to graduate high school with all of us girl. Like, but I had done like, so my high school consisted of, I was the president of this, community service club. So like I did, 4 trips with, if you know, the AmeriCorps, we did like these National Relief Network trips with the AmeriCorps and like huge, national relief organizations all around the world or all around the country. So we went to 4 different places and like we helped with after floods and before floods, actually, like in the midst of a flood, we went down there and like we're doing sandbags like while this the Red River in North Dakota, I think that was it, right? We went to Kentucky too. We went to Kentucky, North Dakota, West Virginia, and Tennessee, maybe? Oh my god, it was wild. It was so fun. So like, that was my high school. I was like leading this club. Every Thursday I went to a nursing home to bowl with old people. I like led this bowling club. On Tuesdays we did bowling at the other nursing home across town. Like, I was just like, we went and did, we ran a karaoke club or a karaoke event out of, the homeless shelter. That's just like a couple miles from my house now. Like, downtown Grand Rapids, like, we did all sorts of random stuff. Like, every day of the week I was busy, like, doing something. Like, I was in all sorts of, like, extracurriculars and student council and, like, all sorts of crazy stuff I was doing. So I was like, there's, like, I don't know what, how I got on this story. So random. I guess I was just talking about how short I was. But yeah, so I was never really, like, made to have a small personality. Like, I was running things and, like, always talking to people, met, like, hundreds of people throughout, like, those 4 years, probably thousands, realistically, from all the different events I was doing, and, worked a lot with the Interact Club, the Rotary Club, which is, like, the adult version of the Interact Club, and, yeah, 6'5 is super tall, exactly. He doesn't realize how tall he is, just like I didn't realize how short I was. Big heart and a little body. That's true, though. That's the truth. Oh my gosh, it is so hot in here. Now I've got this bacon, and I'm not even baking yet. The oven's baking. I'm baking. There's no baking is baking yet. Let's do the Buckeye cookies, because I think these are going to be super simple. I also got, all heart. That's cute. We'll just put that there. Oh, it's too warm. Holy cow. Us littles like to be big, so we make up for a small size. Yeah, right? Like, when people say Napoleon syndrome, you're like, okay, I see it. No one's arguing with that one. So if we're loud, make a big stand up for something. Yeah, exactly. We stand up for what we believe in, that's for sure. All right. Till I get back. And ain't got time. Shake your hand. Till I get back. Where is that? And ain't got time. Shake your hand. In the pocket till I get back. Ain't got time to shake your hand. Aww, in the Discord and everything. You just take care of that so fast. Thank you so much.
Amazing. Yeah, you're best. Not small, bite-sized. Ooh.
I like that way too much.
That's cute. Where is that? Normally that's where I keep all of my baking bowls. Now I'm like... Now I'm not seeing it anywhere. I'm wondering where I... How did I hide it on myself? Wait for a man and I ain't got time to shake your hand. Okay. These are all DMCA free music, so I know I had somebody say that they didn't want to stream because they didn't want to get like crap for, and which I know the music, they're so ridiculous about the music. But this is Grammatic, who makes all like free to use music, which is really nice, and it's on every major music platform, so I do like that. Garden name is Guard of Beans. Oh my god, I bet mine's probably Carly Boo. That's my guess. I'm excited to see. Ain't got time to shake your hand. Well, without this bowl, makes it kind of hard to start this project. Where the heck else would it be? My house isn't this big, that's the other thing. My house is only so big. And as you can see, most of my baking stuff is over there already, but I did organize everything. So this is the problem when you organize. Sometimes you lose things. Does anybody else have that when they organize? Just me? That would have been a good spot for it. Well, you guys, what a dilemma. Is it in the fridge? I don't think so. Oh my goodness, I think I left it at my grandma's house. No, because last time I just baked some of these pumpkin, which they were so good. I made these pumpkin chocolate chip cookies. Oh my god, I should really make these on stream. They were amazing, and I bought extra ingredients because after I made them once, I literally ate the whole thing and then made a whole new batch. I was like, well, I need to use the rest of these pumpkins. What's up, Born to, what are you doing in here, Born to Grind? Aren't you still streaming? Did I miss something? Did you just get done? What are you up to now? Aren't you still playing God of War? Your tab is up. Man and the Frogs, what's good, Mason? Pumpkin chocolate chip cookies, dude. These literally, they're like so, I know everybody hates this word, but I'm sorry. They were like so moist. They were like so like melt in your mouth, like buttery, pumpkin-y, like soft and chewy cookies. Oh my god. He's always streaming, I know. He's always streaming and somehow always in chat too. I'm like, bro, how you do it? I'm gone, like to hate me when you're gone. I know, man, everyone hates it, but I gotta say it because it's the truth. There's like no word that describes these cookies better than. Dang, alright, we're getting down. Okay, so we're hand mixing everything today, y'all. That's what that means. We're gonna roll up our sleeves like an adult. We're gonna mix it the old-fashioned way. It never bothered me either. So Bishu, he's on Twitch. Oh, look at my hair is just coming loose. Releasing it, y'all. I'm gonna glow up, no fronts. just looking at your channels, like, what do I cosplay as? Ooh, good question.
So right now,
good question. So at this point, I don't have any, like, real costumes, like, nothing. I have things that I could, like, create out of what I already own. I have just, like, a lot of, like, I have this one dress that I bought, I might have a picture of it on Instagram, actually, but it's got, like, little gold buttons down it, and, like, a little, like, it's dark blue, it's like a, it's, I call it my sailor dress, it's, like, really cute.
This might be a little intense.
cosplaying right now, yeah, look at, I love Lucy. No, I could, yeah, that's the thing, is I want to do anything, literally. Like, I feel like the possibilities are endless. Like, as long as I have an idea in my head, I would recreate it. That's pretty much what I do for Halloween every year. Last 2 years I've just been, like, lazy and just did, like, Morticia Adams with, I have a bunch of black lacy clothes, so I just, like, wear layers of black lacy outfits. But I want to do Harley Quinn, I really want to do, I did Poison Ivy 1 year for Halloween, but I no longer have that. I had this green corset lingerie, like, onesie. Oh my god, it was so effing, it was so sexy. Stupid. I found that at Goodwill. It was, like, old-fashioned, but never worn. It was, like, so small. It was, like, nobody could ever wear it, but it was beautiful. Like, oh my god, it's gorgeous. I don't know where it is now, but that was a good one. So I think that I'd probably do something like that. Like, half, you know, because there's a lot of, like, I was just looking at a bunch online. Like, I'd love to do some, like, of the Genshin Impact outfits. And, oops, smacking the oven. I'd like to do pretty much any redhead. I'd really like to do Mrs. Incredible. I think that would be just, like, the easy, like, one-piece fitted suit. Like, the spandex suit or whatever. Like, so cute, comfortable, like. That's mostly what I was looking at, was, like, outfits I can get on Etsy, like, anything I could dress of. My Poison Ivy outfit was fire, hell yes. Oh my god. It was. It literally was fire, holy crap. There's one picture of me wearing it, I think. Oh no, that was the year I dressed up as, Catwoman. I had a black corset that I wore with black leggings and my black leather jacket. And I had, that's when my hair was, like, this short and, like, curled. It was cute as heck. What else? I would do anything, though. Like, I'm totally down to dress up. I love dressing up. It's so fun for me. That's, like, for sure my inner child, like, gets to let herself out. Donna from That 70s Show. I did that for, Halloween right after Elon was born. I have these high-waisted pants that are actually from the 70s that are, like, jacket material. Like, they're yellow with purple and light green pinstriping down it. Like, they're freaking amazing, these pants. And, they're, like, a little bit high-waisted, and then I wore this, like, crop top, like, strappy tie-around shirt. Oh my god, I looked so hot. Because right after I had Elon, I, like, went back. I had a hotter body after Elon was born than I ever did before I had Elon. Because, like, I had these boobs all of a sudden. I had no belly. I was, like, six-pack abs after I had him. Like, I looked freaking sexy. And we go over to the house next door, to this party, Halloween party. This is, Elon had been born, but he was still in the NICU. So Derek and I go to this party next door where his ex-girlfriend lived, the one that he decided to leave me for when I got pregnant with Elon. And so I go over there looking like that right after giving birth, and she's just like, oh my god, did you really just have a baby? She was literally so mad, and I was like, sorry, dude. Oh my god, picture didn't happen. Oh my god, I know. I actually don't, Derek never took pictures of me, so I know we didn't get a picture together. But I looked so good that night. But I would totally recreate that outfit anytime. Groceries arrived, yes! She's my all-time favorite redhead. I totally support that. We'll get dressed up. We'll do it again. I love that energy, dude. I was such a bitch. I was like, F you, dude. Like, you wanna because we're friends. And I was like, girl, you gonna do this to me when I'm pregnant? Then she went and got pregnant by somebody else, thank God. And I was like, now you know how it feels, hopefully, to like, how I must have felt, I guess I should say, if someone had done that to her. Imagine not taking pics. I know he never took pictures of me. I was like, dude, I wore the coolest outfits when we were together, too, because we used to go to shows like 3 to 5 times a week, literally, every week. Nothing bitchy about wanting to prove you're not accepting people's bullshit. That's true. I was like, listen, like, you know, like, you can try to be petty and shit, but, like, I know my worth. Like, I'm confident as fuck. Like, you're gonna try to make me feel bad about me? You can't. Like, you can take this man if you want this man. This man has literally zero to do with my worth. You know, I do not base my worth on what he thinks about me or whether or not we're together or who he's sleeping with, because that does not concern me. If you want to make a mistake, you can make a mistake. If you want to feel bad about how you want to look, you can feel bad about how you want to look. But that does not reflect on me anymore. Always take pictures of my dates and girlfriends, because you're a real one, Dr. Oko, and we know this about you. Straight up, you genuinely are. Like, I want, paparazzi energy for my man, right? I want to be like, hey, I appreciate you, like, you're beautiful, like, when they're just when you're just sitting there, like, there's so many moments that, like, I've been standing there with Elon, or, like, we're doing something, we're playing, and, like, I'm like, man, like, it'd be so nice if somebody was just here to take a photo of it, or, like, to enjoy this energy, but even when they were, you know, they don't notice it or whatever. So, love taking candid photos. Exactly, when you're like sitting there, you, my woman, are freaking amazing. You keep doing you. F everyone else. Yeah, you're a real one. When they're not paying attention, right? When they're looking off into space, or they're like looking at their food, or they're like I love taking pictures of my friends when they're like in the middle of a happy moment. Like, my favorite photos are when people are hugging. And when people are, like, seeing each other for the first time, right? Like, friends, family at parties when they first, that's the moments that I try to capture, are, like, when people are, like, that pure, raw, unbridled emotion of people just, like, loving on each other, like, just like, oh my god, you're here! Got this great one of, my sister and our friend Jesus, just, like, embracing, at this Christmas party, and it was so sweet, and I was like, yes, this is what I want to see. Some people don't like cameras. I hate them. Oh no. Yeah, some people really don't like cameras. That's okay. I wish my other half would either do that or let me do that, but he's not into it. Yeah, I love taking pictures. I wish I could take pictures of me. Like, I wish I had a clone of me. Nothing lasts forever. I had the song stuck in my head earlier. Don't you know that nothing stays the same? She's already in my head. And I'm stuck on those things she said when she said, I won't be around for you. Around for you. Capturing those moments is so precious. Yeah. I still keep pictures of my ex in a separate HD. Can't stand to look at them. But I don't want to let go of the memories. Oh, heart. I have a few of, there's like a couple exes that I was like, no. But there are like a few photos of people. And it doesn't really hurt. Some people I'm still friends with. Some people it's just like we moved apart or we had different paths in life, and that's okay. I try not to. For a long time, I lived like in that depressive state of mind of like always missing things and always feeling like, even in the moment, that like thinking about how this moment was fleeting. And like, so now instead, when I look back on those memories, it's like I get to relive that memory in whatever mindset I want to relive it in. I'm just trying to read chat. I'll take pictures all day, but I haven't been in one since 09 or so. Oh my goodness. My head. Wow, that's so long. My head. I used to work for a company that rescued horses as a photographer.
I loved it. I love horses so much. Oh my goodness. Our girlfriend's daughter was playing hide and seek with other kids, was hiding behind a bench her mom and I were sitting at. She came out and stated, hiding behind her family. Oh. Oh. Wait, is that because of a camera? I missed this. Same, I love my DSLR, but again, I'm forced to be in front of a lens. I'm so awkward, like I forgot how to be human. Oh my gosh. They didn't like to be in pictures, but had no choice to. I felt so bad. Oh, poor horsies. Oh, if someone tries to force me in front of a camera, I'll cover my face until they go away. Dang, you're just like, I'm not doing this. You can't make me. You will not force me into this. I do not approve. Alright, we're gonna make these cookies. IRL. We're making them, like I said, the old-fashioned way, everyone. So, what do we do first? Peanut butter and powdered sugar. This is gonna be a really tough one to stir by hand. So I kind of want to do... Should we do the pumpkin cookies instead? It's less steps. And then for the first ones, we have to wait. Well, I mean, we've already been talking. We could talk a half an hour away. That's not a problem. The other ones are pumpkin. So it's flour, baking soda, pumpkin pie spice, in a large bowl. Beat butter and sugars until light and fluffy. Oh yeah, see? That's why I like using the stand mixer. Does beat them really nicely together. Wish them almost captured. Aww. Yeah, that's sweet. Alright, I am thinking we'll just do the buckeyes because I've been wanting to make them for a while. I gotta get this peanut butter out though. That's what I'm trying to do right now. I have to move the camera so that I can open my cabinet. Hello. Just my eyes right now. Okay. I have so much peanut butter right now. It's ridiculous. I, like, bought a backup peanut butter, and then I bought another backup peanut butter, and then I realized I had a backup peanut butter already, so now I have, like, 4 jars of peanut butter that I need to use. Not a problem. Not a problem. We can eat peanut butter around here. Alright. 1¼ cups. Spatula as well. What time is it, by the way? Gotta keep on track. There's a schedule. 5:47. Don't you have a meeting? Hang on a second. We're on the time. Same time zone, right? Okay, this is gonna be so much fun. You're gonna come over here. This is why we got the spatula. 1, 2. Echo? Alexa? Echo? Skip. I'm like, nope, not this song. I gotta unlike that song. So every time I hear it, I wanna skip it. So that's when you're like, this song no longer resonates with me. Ooh. This is a good one though. Oh, this one's called Baywatch. I love it. BAE, Baywatch, by the way. Alright, 1, 2, 3. So we are doing 1¼ cups of peanut butter right now. Y'all can't see me, but way down here. Don't look at my oven's a little dirty, but that's okay. Here, we'll put this here. Good work. Good work, Carly. What is everyone else up to this lovely time zone? Right, so there's 1 cup and the extra
lot of peanut butter, y'all. Just a lot of peanut butter. Peanut butter. Waiting for the snow that was claimed to come tonight. Yeah, I know. They were piping it up, man. Something fierce. I mean, it's been 35 in Houston, actually, so anything is possible, man, right now. I meant to send warm, I gotta send some warm vibes. But I know Granny Savage kind of wanted it to snow a little bit for her grandkids, which I think is really sweet, so I don't know. I'm kind of living off for that, honestly. I don't want to send warm vibes until I know that everyone has gotten all the cold they needed. That's so silly to say, but we live in Michigan here, so, like, we're used to it. We're like, we know humans can handle it. They don't like to. None of us like to. We don't even like to, but we do it. It was hyped so much. There's no food at the grocery store. Shoot, I forget y'all do that. Chill out. It's gonna be fine. Oh my gosh. Oh, thank you. Yeah, this is my hair. I curled it and then I put it up in a bun because I was like, I gotta cook. Like, I can't cook with my hair. Like, no way. Powdered sugar than this for some reason. Right now we are making buckeye cookies. I should probably have made dinner first, but we are not. We are making the cookies first. So I'll show you the picture, just measuring out the powdered sugar. So it's a cup and a quarter of peanut butter, so mostly peanut butter, and then only a third cup of powdered sugar, so not bad. Not too much sugar. It's a quarter cup. You just need a little more. I'm like, I don't think it's gonna hurt if we put too much sugar in, right? I've never heard of that. Well, okay, yes I have. It's definitely, things can be too sweet. Things can definitely be too sweet. Honestly, it's probably a little over, yeah, it's about a half a cup. Just about. We're okay with it. We're gonna mix that much in and see. Back from our walk. Oh good, I'm glad. I hope you had a wonderful walk. I was just thinking, I'm like, Ben's probably just about done with his walk. I literally almost said that. That's so funny. We're good. We're mixing up the peanut butter and the powdered sugar right now. We also realized that I do not have my my mixing bowl. I left it at my grandma's house the other day when I went over there, so we'll have to go get that from her and be able to use that on stream instead of making it myself. But right now we're using our arms. Oh, and I meant to share this on Discord and never did. At least we updated the stream stuff. Oh man, this won't be nearly as smooth as it would be normally. I am lazy, y'all. I don't like to stir on my own. Especially peanut butter and powdered sugar, it's like cement. Oh my goodness. I need a machine to do this for me. Or I need to work out more. Holy cow. Spirit posted a Discord for me. Thank you, Spirit. Dessert before dinner is the way to do it. I don't know. Are you a good influence, Spirit? Normally you are. I'll accept it. Oh my goodness, okay. Whew. We're gonna add the rest of that sugar because we're feeling like we need to. There's a reason we scooped it. Okay. And then we're gonna make these into two. We're gonna scoop them using a small cookie scoop, which we do not have. We'll just use a spoon. Two spoons. Scoop mixture into 22 balls. I'm prepared. If you don't have a cookie scoop, they're a very useful tool. Love them. Koopa Slayer, how's it going? Yeah, that's how we get our big arms. Ooh, and lifting babies. Tossing babies into the air and catching them. And also fighting bears with our hands. You know, just like mountain lions for fun. I'm good, how are you? Have I been playing any games? I've been playing Sims. I have been absolutely loving The Sims. I actually had a super slow day at work where I played The Sims all day on my shift. But also got work done. I was very productive at the same time, so. It was very interesting. Don't tell them, I shouldn't have said that. I'm totally liable now. Peanut butter and powdered sugar, you guys. Is there anything better? I can tell you, not very many things. It's been amazing. I love it. I literally called my mom and told her about it. I made a Benatron. I made a Bentron Sim. He's got a fox. His fox is named Foxy McChubbs. It's not a fat fox. Okay. I don't know why that was his last name. It just was. I was like, this is just your fox's name for some reason. It's so cute. Fox fighting bears with their bare hands. Yeah, Foxy McChubbs. My good old boy. The good boy. It's really cute. They like, so funny. So my sim was amazing. Her name was Cosmic Cosmic. She moved in and like loved music and working out and all this stuff, and she met this woman who ended up being her partner, whose name was Katrina, who lived nearby, and they like both loved working out, and like I was a dog lover, so she like bought me a dog, and then we ended up getting married in the park. And then literally the night that we got married, we came home and I was like making her laugh, and like, because I was hilarious, and like making her laugh, and she was laughing really hard, and then all of a sudden she became hysterical, which I've never seen happen in any Sims character ever. And so like all of a sudden, any games I've been looking at or want to play? Good question. I've been looking at Jackbox games, honestly. I kind of want to get some Jackbox games just to play on stream. Which reminds me, Broomstick and I, Broomstick with a S-C-H-T-I-C-K, is doing a stream. We're doing a stream tomorrow night at 8 p.m. So 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, by the way. It's gonna be great. I'm super excited. Jackbox is so fun, especially the murder mystery one, whichever one that is. Is that six? I was just looking over all of them. I think the Jackbox game, but I meant to buy them, during the sale, but I totally forgot. This song I always think of Super Mario Sunshine, just the music in that game, so cute. Oh, Sim Story, exactly. Oh shoot, yeah, that's right. What was the question? Have I ever played What the Dub? What the Dub is really funny. Yeah, I think we played that with Karina. What was the other question? About the games? Classic ADHD. I know. And you know what? My family has diagnosed me with everything under the sun except for ADHD. I'm like, how did you guys not just realize every freaking symptom that you've ever seen in me is really just ADHD? Ghost Bloop, you don't know what I look like? This is me. Are you saying I wasn't pretty before? I've looked like this for a while. Not ever. Not forever. Actually, a few years ago, I was not this pretty. I have definitely gotten better looking with age. Oh my god, my sim wife, she got hysterical. It was horrible. She gets hysterical. Okay, it wasn't horrible. She was laughing. She was loving my joke. It was so funny. I was like, awesome. Then I was like, wait, hang on. This doesn't seem right. There's something going on. Because, you know, you just, like, get panicky sounds, and they give you all these warning sounds, and you're like, hold on a second. And then you don't stop it in time, and then all of a sudden the Grim Reaper is there, and you're like, what's going on? And she's like, she can't breathe because she's laughing so hard. And I'm like, what is this, a real thing? I've never seen a sim do this. And, yeah, apparently it's a thing. And so my wife died in the bathroom in front of me. I ran in there to save her and, like, pleaded for her life from the Grim Reaper, and he was like, no, and just killed her off right in front of me. I was like, why? We literally just got married. So my sim was half happy, half sad, because she was happy from just getting married, but sad that she had lost her spouse. I was like, this is so messed up. Like, oh my god, it was terrible. Sounds like you're digging a hole, buddy. I'm not. You need a death flower to plead to the Grim Reaper? That's a thing? Oh my god, who knew? Last year when we met, you were something. Now you're all pretty. How rude. How dare. Well, I don't remember what I looked like last year. There are some videos, some clips from like some of my first videos where I thought I looked pretty good, I guess. I have braces now. I feel like that kind of decreased my prettiness, but alright. Has 3,000 of them. You have Sims 4 seasons. They only grow in winter. Oh my god, I had no idea. You have 3,000 of them? You just have a house where you just are constantly, like, propagating these death flowers so that you can always plead to the Grim Reaper. Oh my god, that's crazy. I love it though. I'm just looking around for my cookie tray. Alright, team. Oh my god, oh no. You make super expensive drinks with them as well. That's so funny. How random. Oh my goodness. Wow, weird. Alright, we gotta make these into... My bad. I just realized I should be, I'm gonna put some parchment paper down, actually. Or wax paper, I guess. Since we're just breaking them. Thank you so much, Echo. That was a beautiful song. I have a fridge that's 3/4 the size, so I just had to rearrange some things to fit that in the freezer, but it's good. Aw, you're welcome, Ghost Floof. I'm super glad that you, like, stopped in and that we got to see you in other streams, too. Like, you know, we do, like, you know, we want to support people. We want to show them how much we love them, like, and part of us always does have that mentality of, like, am I doing enough? Like, do they know how much I appreciate them? Like, you know, we just have this mentality of, like, no one really, you know, maybe I don't say it enough, so, and I'm gift giving is one of my love languages, so, when words fail, sometimes gift giving, you know, will fill that for me, so, I totally felt where you were coming from as well, and then I was also, like, prompted to say that for some reason, so I was like, you know, I'm just gonna say this, I guess, hope that it's taken well. It's officially 31 degrees. Time for everything to freeze and shut down. Time for the end of the world. It's officially the day after tomorrow. Yeah, when the house catches on fire a lot, you're just like, I'm done. I'm done with this. Same. So much sameness. I want to give to others and inspire others. Too stubborn to really take advice when it comes to me, though. Yeah. I started realizing, like, if I'm not taking care of myself first, like, if I can view myself the way that other people view me, and for me that means the way that I view other people, you know, how I love them and admire them, want to help them, want to be there for them, want to support them, is how people view me as well. Like, that's a reflection, you know, we're a reflection of each other. So then shifting that perspective for me and, like, actually reminding myself every time I'm looking at somebody on, like, that pedestal-esque view is also how people look at us. So we have to kind of, you know, both humble ourselves when we look to other people as well as recognize our own divinity. So, like, you know, recognizing that we're neither perfect nor, you know, flawed. Like, we are just that perfect combination of perfectly imperfect, doing the best we can, inspiring some people, infuriating other people. Like, you know, we're never gonna please everyone, but the best we can do is please ourselves. But do you know how much we appreciate you? Exactly what I mean, Benetron. Because the way that as much as I appreciate you, you, I hope, appreciate me. You know, like, we'll never know 100%, but, like, it's nice to feel that mutual appreciation, or, like, to reverse it in my mind anyway. I was thinking it was a little loud, but then I was like, actually, this song is a bop. We can't match up to everyone's expectations of what a human being should be. Exactly. And then some people are going to look at us and be like, but you're perfect in my eyes. And we're going to be like, well, that's cool, but are you perfect in your own eyes? But what about that? But turn it back around, you know? Okay, now I'm hungry for dinner. Oh, I've got my smoothie here. Don't forget your smoothie. Unstoppable Hella in the house! What's good, Hella? Hello! Wow, I'm so excited you're here. Okay, everybody, you want to see a top-notch sim streamer? Unstoppable Hella. Holy cow, amazing. I love your builds. I love you. I love your personality. Real, honest, open about health and mental health and everything, basically. You're just, like, open, honest, like, straight to the point. I love the bluntness, I love the realness, but also the kindness and the support and the love. Like, sorry, I felt like that was a little loud. I'm doing pretty well. I didn't sleep super well last night, so I did wake up kind of tired. But I got to play with Elon this morning, and that was exhausting but fun. And then he got picked up this afternoon about 1, so then I kind of got the afternoon to myself. I ended up staying up late. One of my friends wanted to chat. He was, like, having a rough time. We've known each other just through music locally, and so we were just chatting and catching up, and it was so fun to just, like, talk about our kids and just talk about, like, life and how crazy everything's been, and It was nice. He was like, he needed a boost. I didn't realize I needed a boost, but sometimes when you're like helping lift up someone else up, you're like, you end up saying something that you didn't know you needed to hear, right? So it was totally like that. It was just one of those conversations where you're like, oh my god, like, dude, I needed to say that because I needed to hear it for myself too, of like, you know, because he was ranting about one of his friends, and I was like, man, I was like, but have you talked to him about it? Like, have you had a conversation? Like, open up that dialogue? And so just kind of like looking at things differently and like simplifying, you know, conversations and situations that we overcomplicate. Dang it, Dr. Oko, you always do this to me. I was like, dang it, every time he asks me, I almost don't want to tell you because I'm like, he's gonna buy me something. He's too nice. Too nice. You are so sweet. Those 2 a.m. panda streams don't help with sleep either. Anon, those were so funny though. Oh my god. Love those uplifting conversations. Yeah, just needed. Who knew it? Who knew it too? But sometimes they are. That is such a good smoothie. Holy cow, I'm like slamming it. So I got my new protein powder in, which I was super pumped about. So this is the new style of packaging. Still a pound of protein powder, but shorter, slightly shorter container, and like new style of font that I really love. It looks super classy. New style of like layout for the design. Signed by Dr. Shackley. Like, super cool. I was like, dang, this looks slick. So this is the old style. We'll show you. Old style. Cute. Pretty cute. This is good summer. Good summer. Then they were like, you know, I think we could make this with less plastic. So same size around, but shorter. And still packed. It's a little heavier, honestly. They like still packed all of it inside here. And so they're always trying to use less plastic in their packaging. They use hardly any, like, wrapping when they package it. They pack it so tight all together. Like, this is how it came. Like, zero plastic, because this is all the biodegradable, like, corn plastic. And then, or recyclable. You can either recycle it. Yeah, these are all recyclable. So, this is how it all came. It was literally all packed in here, just perfectly Tetris, and then some of the vitamins, excuse me, were in there. Awesome. It came in 2 days. We ordered that 2 days ago. Oh my gosh, you're gonna love it. Yeah, we got, we did the chocolate plant protein powder. We did a scoop of their greens powder, which was delicious. This is like their organic greens booster, so it's powdered kale, powdered spinach, powdered broccoli, with like all these vitamins in it, vitamin K, calcium, iron, magnesium, sodium, potassium, lutein, and something I can't even pronounce, zeaxanthin, that's probably right. Super easy way to get your greens in. So that we did frozen. I did like a pineapple mango, like the tropical blend today, with, like I said, the chocolate powder as well as the chocolate collagen powder. So it's double chocolatey. I'm on the very last of that. What else did I put in there? I put a scoop of chocolate ice cream in there. I did some oat milk, which was delicious. And some of the strawberry protein powder, actually, too. So it's strawberry, chocolate, fruity. I did a whole banana. I always have to do a banana in my smoothie. The smoothie doesn't taste quite right if it doesn't have a banana in it, in my opinion. You're so nice, dude. Seriously, like, you are a real one. Like, when I say that, I'm not just saying that. Like,
If you guys do not follow Dr. Oko, OMG, give this man a follow. Top tier human being, super sweetheart, loves to support other streamers. I just can't say enough good things about you. Like, you have just been such a great, like, just a beacon of light and joy and kindness. And, like, I wouldn't have I wouldn't have my favorite game in the world, Sims, right now if it wasn't for him. Like, I would have, it's been so nice to play video games again. Like, and it's been the only game that will work on my computer. Like, I can't get it. Oranges are your favorite. I don't think I'd put oranges in my smoothie. Actually, you could do an orange juice. I have this one they call a sunrise smoothie at my favorite breakfast place. And it's orange juice, Greek yogurt, mango. It's like all orangey yellow things. It's like really tangy and delicious though. So actually you could do a really good orange smoothie. I won't eat a banana plain. I will put it on like peanut butter sandwich or blend it up in something so that I don't know what's in there. But like, I don't like just plain bananas either. It's been some years since I've seen someone smile so much while talking about all these ingredients. Oh my gosh. Thank you, Ghosty. I appreciate you. Gassing you up. Yeah, dude, you do the same though. You're such a nice guy. I wouldn't put oranges in a smoothie. I eat them whole. I would do orange juice in a smoothie though. Okay, you have the oranges. That's all you. I don't know. I like oranges, but... Oh man, it's rough out there, man. People are feeling it. People are feeling rough right now. So, I'm trying to think of what else was in there. I think that was pretty much it. I try to keep them pretty simple, like 5 ingredients or less. Just like, I don't think you need that many things in it, really. Simple, the simpler the better most of the time. So we've got the peanut butter balls freezing and no alarm set because I totally forgot. Hey Google, or Echo, set 20 minute timer, please.
20 minutes.
Oops. Such chill vibes. So chill today. You guys are so sweet. Yeah, it's so good to have these, like, healthy stuff, because I don't like to eat, like, I don't like to cook, like, a bunch of veggies. Usually I just, if I get them, I don't cook them in time, and then they're never good when I want to eat them. Banana, blueberry, raspberry. Ooh, I can't do raspberries. I have really, like, the shape of my teeth are super deep in the back. So if I eat raspberry seeds or even drink them in a smoothie, they get stuck in my teeth. It's crazy. Should I just avoid them now? That's a good one. All right, y'all. What should we make for dinner, though? That's the real question. This is what I want to make again. The crispy chicken and mashed potatoes. What did I say? Oh my god, y'all, stop. Oh, I still gotta make the cookie part of these. Which dish do you like to make the most? That's a great question. Like dinner dish? Like food dish at all? Y'all are so sweet. Gonna be love.
Gonna be love. This one for
gosh, you guys. I forgot to tell you. I got so many things. It's not enough good excuse to not eat raspberries. Dude, I still eat them. I'm digging back in my teeth with my tongue, just like thinking about it. Look at. It's like the Grand Canyon in there, yo. The raspberry stuff. It's horrible. It could take like, literally, they could be stuck in there, like stuck. So sometimes it gets like panicky and I'm like, oh my God, there's a seed in my tooth. And I'm like freaking out. So it's like, it's a lot of in my headness. I do still eat them. Sometimes I love seedless raspberry anything, but yeah, they used to be my favorite fruit. Honestly, they were my favorite fruit for a long time. But I really like Honeycrisp apples. Like, I've always loved apples, and I just was like, that's such a basic fruit that can't be my favorite fruit. But legit, it is like a freshly picked Honeycrisp apple. That's all I need. Okay, totally getting distracted here. So I got a surprise gift. Can I make apple pie? I actually make a lot of apple butter is my personal favorite thing to make. I've not made an apple pie, but I do have actually two pie crusts that I need to use. Actually three, because I got a graham cracker crust and then two regular pie crusts. So, I kind of want to make pie. Oh, how's it going? What is a putter? Wait, what did I miss? Apple butter with a B. Apple butter. Like, what's for dinner? We're actually making dessert first. So, we're currently making buckeye cookies, which are gonna be effing delicious, let's be real. Peanut butter, powdered sugar are in the middle. You freeze that, and then you wrap a cookie around it. What could be better? Baddest woman on Twitch. Thank you so much, everybody. my Twitch boyfriend Anon, who I've never met or seen in real life, or known for longer than a day. Apologies, tonight is an affection. Oh no, can't hear well. Oh no, I also mumble. And both of my parents have hearing problems, so it's not Twitch boyfriend spot. Oh my God, it was so funny too. It was so late at night. We were all just like goofing around. This random kid started hitting on me. This is how it started. Random kid started hitting on me, and then, it was like this whole telenovela that we were all messing around in our friend's stream. It was so late. I was so sleepy. And then this guy was trying to like get to know me. He's like, I wanna get to know you, blah, 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 or date you or something. I don't know what he was asking. He asked me to hang out, I think was what it was. He's 22. Yeah, kid. In my opinion, walked in the door and bawled out. You were just like, well, you came in and you were just like, hey, listen, like, you can't, you gotta show her that you can, or maybe Artie said that, you gotta show her that you can be the butt of the joke. And we were all just like giving this kid a hard time. Well, because I was just telling him, I just gave him shit. I was literally just like, hey, you need to go host Panda stream. Why aren't you hosting? Because we're trying to get her to 25 average viewer count. I'll be 29 in 40 days. Already said it. Okay. Yeah, you were just like asking. You just asked if I needed a massage, and like you were just like coming in with all these random. It was so funny. I was like, oh my God, these guys are hilarious right now. But. Yeah, he was just like, I told him he needed to host Panda, and he didn't know how to do it, so I was like, just go to your stream, type /host. That didn't work. I told him just to type raid. Like, it was just a totally random conversation. And I was like, good job, I'm so proud of you. Like, you did it. You figured it out. And, oh, I forgot. That one was so good. And then that, dude, that emote, I need that emote. Whoever's emote that is, I need to follow them and get that emote right now. That's so hilarious. Oh my god. It's true though. It's so true. Holy cow. Yeah, my birthday, 3-3. I'm 3-3. What are you? When's your birthday? 30 days. Oh my gosh, yeah, you're the end of February. Are you the 23rd then? No. How many days? Even Panda was like, hey, Anon. For real, we were all like, what was that? You said what? March 2nd, Kuba Slayer, we're like birthday twinnies. It's Pisces, actually. I'm a Pisces. I'm a fishy. A spiritual, sensitive little bug. Intuitive. August 13th, Leo. Nice. I love Leos. I have a Leo rising, and my spirit animal is the male lion, so... Yeah, Pisces babies. I knew we were both Pisces. February 20th, that's right. 220. That's so soon. That is a month from now, isn't it? Oh my god, that's so exciting. Taurus, nice. Ghost flip gift and a sub to Kumi. Aw, how sweet. Nice. I'm about to be 29. Oh good, we're all getting up there. Sub gift, yeah, I know, I feel like we need to be doing like a rewards for these, for when people give out subs, like there should be some kind of a like, you get something special for gifting. I don't know what we should do though. What do you guys want? What sounds good? I got new knives. We need gifts. Look at, look at how good this is. This is a mirror. Do you see me? Hi. Look at this Cutco knife. So nice. They sent me this for free.
You're so sweet.
They sent me four knives for free. The evil smile while wielding the knife. I know, right? Spooky. Careful. Watch out. You don't want to mess with me. I got the cheese knife. I was so excited about this one because we cut a lot of cheese in this house. Pun intended. We get the nicest, literally the nicest vegetable peeler I've ever held in my life. Like, it's so smooth. It's like leathery, so it will never, like, you could try to take this from me. It's never coming out of this hand. This grip is ridiculous. And it's like also ergonomically shaped for your hand. I approve. Crazy plus knives. Top tier. Where's my last one? Oh yeah, I gotta wash it. The last one I just used to make a peanut butter brioche French toast, but it's the table knife. It's so nice. It's covered in syrup and peanut butter. I want to lick it really bad. But this is amazing. All the handle, again, ergonomically shaped, all one piece. But it's just as sharp as any of the steak knives, but it's a butter knife. It's the table knife, so good multi-purpose knife. Lick knife, press 1. 11, 1, 1, 1, 1. Was that a set altogether? So I won that for, I started working for this company and, they were like, telling us all about it, and I was like, this sounds like an awesome opportunity. A lot of my friends work in the food service industry, so I sent them like a lot of people's contact information just to offer them a job. Now I have the hiccups from drinking the smoothie. And they ended up sending me, I won all the prizes for sending the most contacts. I sent 444 contacts to them. So they sent me why I won the cheese knife. This is the traditional cheese knife, so this was great. I made a grilled cheese with it last night. It was amazing. Still have yet to use this, but we're going to use this today. And then this is our vegetable chopper. This is one of our smaller hand knives, honestly. They have a butcher knife that's literally a mini machete, and it's freaking beautiful. You can cut watermelon with it, and also anybody who messes with you. What the heck is a cheese knife? Is this. It has holes in it, so it's more aerodynamic. It slides through the cheese easier. Also flat edge, so that you can get as much, you know, depending on how large your block of cheese is. Full size. Made in New York. These are all made in the U.S. They employ a bunch of people who hand grind these knives to perfection. Top tier company, seriously. Get you a Chinese style cleaver. Yeah, Santoku. Santoku styles are my go-to. And we do have a really good cleaver. I haven't even started cooking yet. I'm making the cookies. Yeah, I know, we're all just chatting. Watermelon, and also anyone that messes with you, you know. The two things that you need cut in the summertime. Hot girl summer. Hashtag hot girl summer. So, I think I want to use this, your Cajun Me Crazy cheese. Artesian cheddar cheese with secret Cajun spices. Award-winning cheese. I think I'm going to use this on top of the chicken, and I think I'm going to do this one like... The way that they did this was panko, breadcrumbs, and Monterey Jack cheese. So we'll just do this Cajun white cheddar and breadcrumbs instead. Hot girl summer, I'm dead. I thought that was a pretty good one. That one just came to me. That's honestly, most of my best jokes are like either while I'm in chat or while I'm streaming. Like, I would love to be a stand-up comedian, but it would have to be some kind of like conversational stand-up comedy, because I'm like, it's gotta be a back and forth. Like, someone has to trigger me to make a joke about the situation that's happening. Like, I'm a walking sitcom. Like, I will make jokes, but do something funny. One of my friends at a music festival once yelled that to me across the field. They're like, hey, do something. Or they're like, hey, Carly, tell us a joke. And I was like, hey, do something funny. They laughed so hard. I was like, yeah. Improv style, yeah. I love it. Ooh. All right, don't forget to drink your liquids. Talk English the way US folks do. Completely improperly and like with zero regard for grammar rules. We got a Swain Brady over here. Straight up. And when are they gonna make me the host of Deal or No Deal? They're messing up everything. Me and Tiffany, we could be BFFs right now. I love Wayne Brady. I love the, I used to watch so much, Whose Line Is It Anyway? That was my go-to show, honestly. One time I got a third-degree burn on my arm, and just, like, ended up, watching Whose Line Is It Anyway for, like, hours and hours that night. I'm new here. What are we cooking? Welcome in. Oh, Dan Osprey. Wait. Know you IRL. It's great to meet you. I'm glad you're here. That sounds really familiar for some reason. So tonight we are cooking, we're currently making cookies because dessert first, life is short. Buckeye cookies. If you're a Midwestern, that's what we call these. Peanut butter powdered sugar balls dipped in melted chocolate usually. But this is chocolate cookies wrapped around peanut butter powdered sugar balls. Yeah, I know, delish, right? Super simple recipe. I'm gonna post it on my Discord. The other idea, now that I'm making these and hungry for a real dinner, I bought HelloFresh at one point just because I wanted some new recipe ideas. And they send you these giant recipe cards, which I love. So we're gonna do, I bought chicken last week actually when I grocery shopped, which I normally don't, but... So we're gonna do chicken breast and mashed potatoes, and I don't think I have carrots, so I don't think I can do roasted carrots, but but that's okay. The roasted carrots were really good, though. Highly recommend. I think they were topped with honey, I want to say. These are honey roasted carrots. Oil, salt, and pepper on the carrots. Actually, what did the honey get one? Oh, the honey was for the chicken. Oh my god. Dipping the chicken in the honey. So good. I forgot how good that was. Enamored. I was browsing streams and now I'm stuck here. Can't leave. You're stuck with me now. I'm so glad y'all are here. I'm so glad you guys found me. That's so awesome. Yeah, I haven't done a cooking stream in ages either, but I miss it. Also, if you guys want to follow me further, I'm pretty active on Instagram. I used to post, like, all the time on Instagram. Been a little bit less so lately, but you can follow all my links from the page. Like, my main about me will have, I just was looking at it today. It's got, like, my Amazon wish list, my Discord, my, Get Healthy. So it's going to be the link to all of the Shackley stuff, the vitamins, the protein powder. They have even, like, cleaning products. Like, this is where I get my dish soap. Get Clean dish soap. This stuff is, like, it's so cheap. It's cheaper than Dawn dish soap. It's probably, like, $7 for this bottle, maybe less. I don't know. It has lasted me forever. And then they have giant bottles of hand soap, too, that are just, like, hand soap refillers for, like, $6 or something crazy. It's, like, a gallon of hand soap refiller for so cheap. So, actually, if you, the brand is called Shackley. Here, I'll put up this little thing of greens. Shackley, S-H-A-K. Now you're not going to work light. You're going to be rude right now. Now you're going to be too dark. There, that's better. Okay, Echo, stop. Thank you. Thanks, Echo. Echo, are you listening? Please stop. Thank you. Echo's like, I'm not listening to you at all. She's like, what was that? So if you go to my links, you can just click Get Healthy. It'll take you right to the website. You can just shop there. Honestly, if you have a health savings account, it'll take your health savings account card because it's all, this is the first man to ever create vitamins. So this is like the oldest, longest, vitamin company that's been around. This man, his parents lived on a farm and he was born diagnosed with tuberculosis, which is usually 100% a death sentence. Back in 1900, when he was born, or before then, totally a death sentence. And so they ended up moving to the country, and his parents were like, no, there's a cure for tuberculosis, and it's rest, fresh air, and a good diet. And so they went and took him to the farm, and he ended up healing himself by high school. They were like, mind blown that he had done this. And so his whole mentality is just like, we don't need to listen to doctors. Doctors don't determine our fate. Diagnoses don't determine our fate. You know, there's a lot of things that we can do to prevent illness, and to combat against illness. So I have had a chronic illness for the last like 6 years of my life, probably more. Having to do with like my reproductive issues. So it was like a monthly reoccurring illness that I was like, literally, if you saw me, I was like dying in bed for like a week or two at a time. So like 2 weeks out of the month, I couldn't get out of bed. I couldn't eat or drink anything. I was like, I had lost all this weight. I was down to like less than 80 pounds. I was like pale and just like had no, oh, paler. I had like no energy to do anything. Like I literally thought I was dying. I went to all these different specialists. I had like crazy surgeries and went through the Western healthcare system the way they said I should, with getting referrals, going from doctor to doctor, specialist to specialist. I was dating a guy whose dad was a surgeon, so like he knew everybody. So I thought, okay, I'm doing everything possible. And ended up just like never having any answers. They couldn't figure it out. It wasn't like showing in any of the tests they did, any of the surgeries they did just exacerbated the problem. So it was like, okay, I've had organs taken out of me,
this isn't making it better. Like, my life is still, I'm still just as, like, sick, just as miserable. Like, what's the real problem here? You know, like, what's really going on? And, have realized, like, so much of it was stress induced and just kind of me not knowing how to take care of myself, like, not feeding myself right. And, you know, I just didn't know. I didn't know what I needed or what I should be doing or, like, what was an easy way to get healthy food in, because, like, I was a college student. I was eating, like, fast food and drinking excess amounts of alcohol and slowly killing myself without my knowledge. I was like, I'm fine. Like, I'm tough. And it just was not, yeah, wasn't a good environment for me. So, bye, Dan. Great to see you. Sorry, I'm, like, not even cooking yet. Getting all distracted. I meant to buy more potatoes too, and I totally forgot. But yeah, so it's just kind of, how do I figure this out, basically? And can I figure this out? Or is this something that I'm gonna be sick with forever? I feel like we are definitely friends now. We definitely are. Get to cooking. Yeah, we talk too much. I'm so hungry. Alright. Yeah, we gotta use these potatoes. They're looking ready to be used. You know what I mean? Oh, I'm so glad. I'm like, man, am I rambling? Oh my god! Sorry, when knives work so well that you, like, don't even know you're cutting through a whole potato, you're just like, wow, that was so simple. It literally... Holy shit, you guys. Oh my freaking god, these knives though. Are you joking? Why don't they have people reacting like you normally would if you used a knife this nice in the videos? This knife is so nice. It literally, like, grabs into the thing that you're using and just, like, shoop, does the work for you. You're like, oh my god, I cut a potato. I feel like I didn't cut anything. I just cut air. Potato cut like butter straight. You saw that, y'all? It's just like, shoop. Oh. And, like, so straight down, like, I could cut perfectly. Usually when I cut, my things are, like, all lopsided and a million different shapes, and I'm just, like, because I'm literally, like, sawing through, forcing my knife through. Wow. Like, it's nothing. Are you freaking kidding me right now, though? I can't. I gotta go. Holy crap, this is so awesome. We're just gonna do it this way. Oh my goodness, you guys. So nice. Damn. Yeah, for real. Alright, so we're gonna just put a little bit of water in the Instant Pot. I'm gonna do this the easy way. Little agate guitar pick. So neat, a set of these knives. Oh my god, seriously. Not even a set. Like, if you get yourself one and you're just like, get yourself the vegetable chopper and you're like, now I got this. I mean, you're obviously gonna want more once you get that one, I'm not gonna lie. Like, it's really nice having all of the options. Oh, I didn't even use the vegetable peeler because most of the time I just leave the skin on. Should we see? Let's try it. Nice grip. Oh, there we go. I got a feeling. Ooh. I don't even need to peel these though. The skin is so thin, it barely peels anything off. It's so hard to cut a small piece of this, though. This thing just wants to chop through the whole potato. this song, though. The song is called Honey and Tea. It's so nice. Fun fact, if when you're scraping the veggies off, always use the back of the knife. That's why they make it flat. Whether you're using a Cutco knife or not, like, use the back of your knife for your own sake, because you don't want to be dulling your knife every time you're chopping with it. Oh my god, Phasma, you just missed me losing my crap over these knives. They're so nice. It literally, like, grips the potato as I'm cutting it. Oh, like, let's use this sucker of a potato. Look at those giant potatoes. Quarter of the size of my face. Okay, watch this. It like grips the potato as I'm cutting it. And then like cuts straight down. So like you're not, the knife can't not bend. Like, look how thick this is. Let's see. Compared to another knife. This knife is shit. Oh my god, these knives are so nice. And that's why it has the little curve on it too, so you can rock it. Oh my god, I'm so cooking forever now. I cannot wait to open my own restaurant. Every chef there gets Cutco knives. Oh my god, heck yeah. So me and one of my friends who just moved to Grand Rapids actually, hi my loves! Oh, so good to see you, Kappa! That's guitar. Carly face potato. Official measurement of potatoes everywhere. I love infomercials though. Person slams egg against wall. Do you have a problem cracking eggs? Buy this egg cracker that you'll never use for $19.99. Yeah, exactly. Do you hate cracking eggs? Hate it even more because you'll have a whole nother thing to clean after you're done making your food. Oh, filthy fresh. Thank you. Thank you, Kata. I live at the blue on the black screen. It makes it hard to read the names on my phone, so I haven't been able to read your name. Filthy fresh, I love it. Thank you. Okay, so we got... That's a lot of potatoes already. We're gonna save the last three potatoes. That's probably enough. Sorry, I'm over there pressing buttons on the infomercial. Or on the freaking red at the word infomercial. On
the Instant Pot. Oh, good try, brain. Such a good try, little one. Small brain moment.
Oh my goodness.
Just moving stuff a bit. Oh, I bet the cookies can be made into cookies now. We didn't even make the other part of the cookies yet. We gotta do one thing at a time. We're doing the potatoes are ready. We'll let the cookies be for a minute and we'll do the dinner first. Silly fries are the best. Nice, yes. Oh man, speaking of, it is, I was gonna say, I bet Cosmic Unwind is live. He is. We will finish, we're gonna finish cooking though first, so. We'll get the cheese out, which means we'll get the cheese knife out. Oh man, look at this sexy cheese knife. So nice. I love how this stays pretty clean too. Get a little bowl of lemons over there. They've just been sitting here on the counter. I'm like, I might as well put those over there in a nice little display. Skincare ones are the most BS. I actually, this is the craziest thing too, is like, you're so right, most of that crap is just like something they say and they just put it on some young beautiful woman's face and then they just cover her in makeup and they're like, look at her now. You're like, wow, she looks amazing. You're like, it's not the lotion, it's the lighting. but true also with me. No, there is actually this lotion that I have that, like, I used to have super dark under eye circles and, like, just, like, really dry skin, like, and, found this lotion that you can actually put under your eyes and, like, see a difference within 15 minutes. And I'm like, now this is what I'm talking about. It's something that you can actually, like, see the instant results from. Yeah, incoming infomercial. There's an older commercial of this guy selling a samurai sword. He starts beating it against the table. The sword tip breaks and bounces back at him. What? Oh my god, that's so savage. Dang. Report Strim. Reported. Oh no, one of my friends was like, girl, what eye cream do you use? And I was like, legit, this is the best eye cream I ever used. Normally it's a bunch of BS and you spend like $50 trying to look better and it doesn't work. That is scary as heck. That is savage. Dude, there's, like, back in the day, there was, like, no rules, right? Like, you see commercials now for, you see, like, old commercials for cocaine and, like, old advertising and propaganda for cocaine as, like, the wonder drug. You're like, I go to a lot of antique stores and thrift stores. Like, those are my favorites. And you're just like, there is some crazy shit that doctors used to tell us was cool, y'all. Like, you think they're still not doing that? Like, and just be like, in 50 years, like, whoops, our bad. We had no idea. But we told you all, like, you should believe us. You know, we acted like we had every idea in the world, only to find out we had no idea. So that's the, take a bump. You got a tummy ache? Take a bump. Yeah, literally, legit, dude. They're like, oh, give your kids some cocaine. That'll, fuck, who fucking knows what it'll do? Shoot. We know what it'll do now. Anyway, the whole thing is just, like, mind-blowing. I'm gonna have to amputate your knee. You stubbed your toe. your stomach hurts? Let's take out your gallbladder. That's what doctors said to me just a few years ago. Like, I was 20. I was 23 when I got my gallbladder out. Like, excuse you? Excuse you, y'all? You want to do what? That's what I should have said. But what did I say? I said, whatever you gotta do. If this has even the slightest possibility of making me feel better, I will do it. Take out whatever you need. Take out my stomach. Take out every organ inside me if you have to. That's what I said. Because when you're desperate to feel better, you literally want them to do anything they can. So that's why I'm like, hey, y'all, there's a better way. We don't have to, do it the hard way and the recovery way and the way we think is the easy way is surgery, though, right? We're like, oh, the quick fix. Like, we'll just cut it out of me. It'll be fine. But it's like, there's recovery time, and then your body has to adjust, and you're living without an organ. So, like, your body has to change, whether you recognize it or not. Thanks, Center. Good to see you. So it's just been, like, very, I don't remember what I was even saying anymore. But this is going to be really good.
Really, really delicious.
Oh my god. Wow, that smells better even than I thought it did. Holy cow. Artesian cheddar cheese with Cajun spices. This smells so good, you guys. That's another story. Being the patient. Yeah, is another story, exactly. Well, and the thing was, like, I was pre-med before this. Like, I was going into psychiatry. Almost done. I was 40 credits away from getting my undergrad in cognitive sciences. I was gonna go pre-med was my next plan. Like, I was just getting into the pre-med club and the business club, so I was also thinking about starting my own business because I wanted to do, like, my own private practice type idea, and then, like, do my own independent research for companies. And I was already doing that. I was in an enterprise, humane interface design enterprise. So we did eye trace studies in order to determine, like, the best way. We designed the app basically for the GM cars. So we got to, like, help them design their app so that we worked with the computer science majors and it was us, the cognitive science majors and the computer science majors in this enterprise. And it was so awesome. Like, great group of people, so much fun to be around. Like, we learned so much, we got to do so many cool things. So that was my whole goal, was, okay, I want to do research, I want to help people, make things easier for others, help people heal. Like, that was my whole goal. And I got really sick. I wasn't taking care of my own body. I didn't know how to take care of my own body. I didn't even know it was that important to, like, getting through my college career. So I got myself so sick I couldn't finish school. We are cooking, we're kind of doing this, crispy Cajun chicken and mashed potatoes. We have no carrots. Sorry, carrots. Maybe we do, but I don't think we do. Country Boy Big Daddy, yeah, that's Phil. That's our... Looks good. I know. I'm so excited. So we've got this cheese here. Smells like so good. I can't even describe it. It literally smells like spicy Cajun food and pizza. It's like Italian herbs and spices and Cajun. German or Russian forklift safety one? Oh my gosh, y'all. Okay, so this is why I only cook meat with you guys on stream. Other than what you guys have seen me cook, I do not eat meat at all, ever. Like, literally never. And I'm not a vegetarian. I just usually don't buy it because it's expensive, for one, and for two, I'm, like, very like, kind of a germaphobe in a way. So, like, I'm, like, really kind of freaked out by raw meat and, like, the cleanliness of that, or the lack of cleanliness of that. And so I'm, like, really weird when it comes to meat. So, like, I have to, like, get over this fear of, like, touching the raw meat. like with my bare hands and all this stuff. So I'm like, I have to do it on stream with you guys. For some reason, like, I will not push myself to do it unless I'm streaming with y'all. Like, I've had this chicken in my fridge for like 3 days. I'm like, I gotta use this. I gotta stream and cook this chicken. And I was like, I'm not gonna tell them that. But then I just told you guys that. Tend to wear gloves when dealing with raw meat. Yeah. And normally, normally I have a bunch of gloves actually. That reminds me, because I always. Anytime you go to the doctor's office, take at least a few pairs of gloves, because they don't use it. Just grab the meat. Normally that wouldn't bother me, but in this case it does. I'll grab the meat. Buy yourself some plastic gloves. Terrible for the environment, wonderful for hands. Yeah, I don't buy them. I always just steal them from the doctor's office because nobody can use small gloves. Nobody. Maybe like one person in that whole office could wear the small size gloves. So they're always full. So every time I go to any doctor's office, I take at least 8 to 10 pairs of gloves because I'm like, I hardly ever go to the doctor's. But usually it's a full box, and I'm like, these are just gonna sit here for the next 10 years. Might as well just grab a few pairs. Wash your hands after touching meat. Yeah, but then you have to touch the, if I had like a tap sink where I could just tap it, but then you have to touch the handles. So then I have to deep clean the handles, and then I want to wash them every time I touch it. So then I'm like going back, then I'm cleaning the handles all the time. I'm just like, I'm too in my head about it, is all it is. I know this about me, and this is why I'm admitting it to y'all. Because I'm trying to just get over that whole idea of, like, putting on that face of being a certain way. Same. Steal a box of gloves from the doctor's office. Yeah, you're like, I'm paying to come here. Y'all are gonna charge me for being here. I might as well get my money's worth. You're gonna tell me you can't help me, so I might as well get some gloves for my house. Do vegetables first unless they're being cooked. Yeah, we already did the veggies. We're doing mashed potatoes in the Instant Pot. But still. Oh. Anyway. I was going to grate the cheese, but because it's so small, it just seems silly to grate like the tiny edge. So I'm just going to chop up a little bit of it in. Man, this knife cut's so easy. I'm like halfway through the block of cheese already. Like having so much fun cutting it, I don't want to stop cutting it. That's probably plenty of cheese, maybe not. And then I think we bake this, if I remember correctly. So we'll just go ahead and bake it in the
baking dish, glass baking dish.
Is this the one where we use sour cream on it? Yes, it is.
Heck yeah, this is great. This is all the random stuff that I ended up buying from the store too.
Sour cream and chicken and the cheese. All right, chicken. We're doing it. So this chicken wasn't too expensive. For two chicken breasts from all the no added hormones, no preservatives, no added salt. Was $4.47, so $4.50 for, I think it's two chicken breasts. I don't know if we know. I think they just give us a weight. Okay, and I think we're supposed to like dry it off with like paper towels. I'm like, I've just put my paper towels somewhere too. Perfect. Okay, so. It's not a big deal. All different mushrooms from Whole Foods and spare ribs. Oh my goodness. Yummy. Oh wow, there's a lot in here. One. god, this is two. When you're in here, do I keep some of these in here? I'm not going to use them all. Do I need to reseal this somehow? I'll put them in a Tupperware, actually. That's what I'll do. I'm just talking to myself out loud. Enough mushrooms to freeze for another soup. Nice, you made soup. Oh, yum. 10 mushroom barley beef spare rib soup. Yum. I don't like mushrooms, but lots of people like mushrooms. Let's see. I think I'm going to... This is all dried off now. Put this down like that. That's fine. That's fine. Oh, you know what I'm gonna do as well? Is that weird? Maybe that's weird, though. All I had today was breakfast. All I had today was a piece of brioche toast. I didn't even eat the French toast. I made a piece of French toast for Elin, and then I just ate a piece of the bread with butter on it because it was just as good. Eggs don't really, I don't really eat eggs anymore unless they're like baked into cookies. Just because when they took my gallbladder out, I can't process fats as well. So I don't really eat a lot of fats anymore. So if you don't have your gallbladder or you're going to get it removed, just know that. Kind of sucks, but at the same time, yeah, that's life, man. It's kind of the way it goes sometimes. Okay, chicken. That is good. We do the thing. So. Oh yeah, I was supposed to mix the panko and I forgot to do that. Hey, Echo? Echo. Is my playlist done?
Here's a popular playlist.
Echo, stop. No, don't do that. Stop. Echo's like, oh, do you want to listen to the top 40s? Oh, do you want your stream to get muted immediately? No, Echo. I asked a simple question. Do not overreact. No need to overreact, ma'am. Oh my goodness. Ah, chicken. Look at me, I'm like, just put it on the paper towel again. Just get another piece of paper towel. Don't even let it touch anything. Roll that right away. Wash your hands. Bacon, egg, and cheese biscuits. Yum. Coffee and Jameson now. Eggs, green bell pepper. Yum. Oh my god. That sounds good though. I like, I do this breakfast skillet. That's sausage, green, red peppers, onions, and potatoes. And it's so good. You can add eggs to that, but I don't really. Will. If it isn't Odie milk. How are you today, Oats? Good to see you. Good to see you, cutie pie. I had enough mushroom. Oh yeah, that's right. Nice. I always love having extras to freeze. Well, we're cooking today. We're making some chicken. We're making some cookies. We are currently needing to mix up some breadcrumbs. The girl keeps forgetting. You forget never. Ooh, Carly? These were expired in July of 2020. Do you think they're okay? Do you think they're all right? Asking for a friend. And just like breadcrumbs, right? Panko breadcrumbs? They seem fine. They've been sealed.
I'm not sure.
Echo, do you think I can eat breadcrumbs that are expired?
Here's what I found. It is not recommended to consume breadcrumbs after its expiration date. Was that helpful?
Yes, it was. Dang it.
Thanks for your feedback.
She says no, but I'm not listening to her. She's just being cautious so she doesn't get charged for liability. She has to say that. She's legally obligated to say that. If it's your mom, she doesn't care. You call your mom, you're like, hey mom, what's beeping? I don't have a timer. Oh, the Instant Pot. I was like, my oven is a million years old. It doesn't have a timer. I've never heard a beep in my life. 2 years. It's from, it expired in July 2020. 2020. Yeah, it was an Instant Pot. That's a long time. Yeah, yo, that's a long time. No, don't do it. I know, these are from, like, this, like, I would never have put these in a plastic bag like this. This is just stupid. My ex did this. Don't use that. Yeah, these are totally his. Damn it. Okay, we need new breadcrumbs. Breadcrumb backup plan. What else? What else? I don't think I have other breadcrumbs, honestly. What else do you use to crumble onto chicken? I meant to buy some breadcrumbs too, and I totally forgot. Yeah, it turned off. Or it's on leave on warming. Yeah, I totally meant to buy breadcrumbs and I didn't. I don't know. That's 2 years old. They expired in July 2020. It's 2022 now. It's 2022. They expired 2 years ago, so I don't know. It doesn't smell. If it smells like plastic, that's my go-to. Like, hell no, I'm not using it. If it's been sitting in a bag so long that it's taken on the plastic qualities, that's when it's like, that's when it's like, no thank you. I'm picky like that. Like, because even potato chips, like, even if they're okay, like, they just taste wrong, right? I can't. They don't taste like anything. I can't taste anything. I know! Can you believe it? Odie, I looked at that today. I was like, what the hell? I was like, who are you people? I'm just kidding. I love you guys. I love you guys. I'm like, dang, I'm on Twitch a lot. Because I'm always like, hey, new friends. Do you stream? I stream. You want to follow me? I follow you back. Then I'm like, how am I following 1,000 people? And also, how are 1,000 people following me? I'm so glad you did. Welcome in. I used to have it on followers only chat, so that's how I knew, like, people were following me, because I was like, oh, hello, new friend. Thank you for the follow. Which I never said, but I should have. Sometimes brain just doesn't brain, you know? Alright, y'all. The mashed potatoes. So, cornflakes. Oh, hey. No, I have something even better. I have roasted vegetable flavored crackers that are absolutely... Actually, these might taste like plastic. Hang on. These might be the plastic things I'm talking about. How expired are these, though? Because I was like, these are from Derek, too, so they're probably two. These are also expired December 2020. I just opened these for the first time. Oh, my God. Carly. Like, people are like, time goes by so quickly. And I was like, you have no idea, like, how much that hits me. Watch, yeah, these are 2 years old too. Like, I do not eat enough food. Like, I have so much food here and still grocery shop because, like, we only eat a few things. Thoughts on getting to 1,000? Do we celebrate by flying out to Chicago? Oh my god, that'd be so awesome. Yeah, let's go do something. There's a million things we could do, though, legitimately. I want to go ice skating. I've never been ice skating, and I want to go and learn. So 2 years old breadcrumbs, 2 years old crackers turned into breadcrumbs, or I could, like, crush up white cheddar Cheez-Its is my other thought. And I know, but doesn't that sound fun? One of my friends just showed me a video. If the breadcrumbs have no flavor, they're okay. Yeah, that's true, because these do kind of taste like plastic, I think. Let me remind myself. Cheez-Its. Chips. I love this. Oh, I have a ton of potato chips. I have a bunch of potato chips. Would that be good? Crush up potato chips? Crush them up. Yeah, they don't have a great taste. They're 2 years expired. What the hell is wrong with me? Oh my god. Yeah, potato chips? Okay, I'm down. So good, because I had these potato chips and I was like, what am I gonna do with the bottom of these potato chips that are like, they're kind of stale, they're not good anymore. Cosmic crumb. Keeps in the moisture. Crush them up. Potato chip qigong. Hot Cheetos on chicken is awesome. Dude, I have this recipe in here. I'm so sorry. Oh my god, that was so loud. Don't you know we're streaming? Oh, dude. Where are those? Oh my god, I gotta show you these. They are Hot Cheetos macaroons. Literally made of Cheetos. Is this backwards for you guys? It's backwards when I look at it. I'm like, oh my god. Cheetos, literally a 2 ounce bag of Cheeto Puffs. Oh my god, it's crazy to me. I know, right? That's what I'm saying. I'm like, what? I don't know about that. Chimkem. That's so cute. Okay, crushing up the chips. Dude, I know. People love hot things. Yeah, they must not know that this is from some place in New York too, that recipe. Oh my god, these are gonna be so good. These are sharp white cheddar potato chips, by the way. Kettle chips. Yum. I'm supposed to put this in with butter. I'm so excited right now. It always takes me a million years to cook when I'm on stream with you guys. Like, normally this would be so fast. I'm always like, oh, I can cook so fast. And then I get on here and I'm like, nah, I can just chat a lot. What are freedom fries? Kettle chips are better than original. That's what my sister thinks too. I personally, like, these are my go-to potato chips. Like, this is all I need in my life. Like, Aldi brand cheddar and sour cream potato chips. Some of the kettle ones are just, like, too crunchy, you know? French fries aren't fried in France. They're fried in Greece. Ooh, yum. Grease fries. I see what you did there. Sheesh. Got me. You got me there. Alright, potato chip crumbles. Oh my god, y'all, this is genius. And these are not expired. Okay, maybe they're a little bit expired. Best if used by January 3rd, 2022. So, only a couple weeks. Nobody's mad. Oh my gosh, okay. Potato chips, the crumbles. I'm, like, getting all distracted. Oh yeah, that's right. That's why I got distracted. Okay. Sorry. Why am I getting my face so close to the camera? They say 1 tablespoon of butter, but is that really? Do they really only mean 1 tablespoon? For real? That's not very much. Do they know that's not very much? I think they mean 2. Change the recipe for them. Approximately, thank you. 40 minutes of cooking turns into 4 hours on stream. Exactly, Anon. Like, how have we been on for... We have not been on for 2.5 hours. Thank you. Agreed. Yes. Butter is my friend. My dad gives me such a hard time for it, but I'm like, I'm gonna eat butter, Dad. Till the day that it kills me. Okay. Oh. There's the butter. Yum. Butter. Crumbs. And then the cheese. I'm gonna cube up the cheese then. We're gonna mix the cheese in here. Silly. I have a cheese cutting board, like, specifically for cheeses, and I didn't even use it. Oh, well. Let's see. Fork, stir this up. Mm-hmm. Butter and cheese. And more cheese and potato chips. This is definitely gonna be tasty, that's for sure. I don't think this is really that healthy. This is why I don't eat meat very much. But it's a good little treat. So I do a ton of smoothies and simple things because it takes me too long to do it. Oh my god, yum, it smells so good. The white cheddar, like sharp white cheddar and butter and all these white cheddar chips too. Oh my gosh, that made my nose tickle. Gonna grab a cake, BRB. Oh my gosh, a cake, yum. That sounds lovely. We support. Butter, breadcrumbs, cheese. Oh, and the seasoning. That's right. Before we did the Frank's Red Hot, I think right now we're going to just use this seasoning that I have. I drink Diet Coke so I can eat regular cake. Oh my gosh. You shouldn't drink Diet Coke though. That's such an addiction. There's a lot of, they have like a weird chemical combination that actually leads you to hold weight in your stomach. If you drink Diet Coke, it like holds on to that belly fat. I was actually a junior counselor to a camp counselor who was, she literally was addicted to Diet Coke. She had to drive out and get herself a couple 12 packs just while we were there for a week, and she had to go get herself two 12 packs of Diet Coke. And it was just like, oh my goodness. She was thinking she was being healthy because she was a diabetic, but it was like still not good for us. So this is, I'm sorry, I don't mean to, I should not be telling anybody what to do or not do. That's not my place. Just something that I found out about it. Because also my roommate in college was also addicted to it, and I love her dearly. And just want everybody to be healthy and happy. So this is our El Pastor, Al Pastor seasoning. So ancho and guajillo chili powder. Ancho chilies, cumin, guajillo chilies, black pepper, garlic, onion, salt, apple cider vinegar powder, orange juice powder, pineapple juice powder, Mexican oregano, and cinnamon. So smells so good. Smells like a little bit spicier taco seasoning, essentially, with the cumin smell and the peppers. Really, really good. But like that little bit of orange powder, orange juice powder, and pineapple juice powder, so like a little bit of the citrusiness is really pleasant. So essentially we pat the chicken dry with the paper towels, season all over with salt and pepper, place on a plate, mound tops of chicken with the panko mixture. I thought we were supposed to put sour cream on the chicken as well. Am I wrong about that? In a small bowl, combine half the sour cream. You'll use the rest later. So where's the rest of the sour cream? Sorry, this is such a weird way that they have this. Oh, there. Heat a drizzle of olive oil with scallion whites in an empty pot over low heat. Cook until softened. Return potatoes to the pot. Mash with the remaining sour cream. So the rest of the sour cream actually goes in the mashed potatoes. Yum. A recipe is more of a suggestion. Buttermilk or sour cream is typically the binder. That's what I was thinking too. I know, right? But I guess because it has the butter in it, it just kind of sits on top and bakes the butter and the cheese. But yeah, last time I did, honestly, I just put a smear. I didn't read the recipe well enough. I just did a smear of sour cream on each of the chicken breasts. And then did the breadcrumb mixture on top of that. Just pile it on and it was good. We're gonna just put this in the glass baking dish and bake away. I kind of want to cut this off though. Yeah. Yeah, I do not. I'm not a big fan of like fat pieces on meat. Tendons. I kind of want to pretend like I'm not eating meat, honestly. Just because it's weird to me, but. Love Yourself First playlist, please.
Love Yourself First from Spotify.
All right, chicken. Every time I wash my hands, then I have to touch the dang chicken again. So silly.
Mm-hmm.
So don't do that part unless you want to. You don't have to. It's apparently not required. So we can still put, I know, right? Good lyrics. We can still put sour cream, because I have a whole tub of sour cream, in the mashed potatoes. That'll be great. What is this? How it ends? So that's how these look before baking. There's a lot of white cheddar on there and a lot of white cheddar potato chips. So it's gonna be delicious. Let's do it. So this is supposed to bake at 425 for the carrots, but I'm wondering if we turn it down for when we add the chicken. Nope, I guess that's it for turning it up a little bit, baby. Woo! I wanna make it back. Ooh, thank you. Food! Oh my god, cat, stop! Hi, gorgeous! Wow, hello! We are making Cajun chicken. So I literally just put it in the oven, so it's not even hot yet. Like, literally not even hot yet. So we have white cheddar cheese on here with white cheddar potato chips. I love cheddar. These white cheddar potato chips that we crushed up because the breadcrumbs I have are 2 years expired. I was like, oops. They're 2020? When was that? Nacho, thank you. Gifted 3 months of sub to Cat. Oh my god, what a homie. Wow, Nachito! Yay! Wow, we appreciate you. Thumping your doorstep. You what yours yet? And Ingleside. Wow, I'm so glad y'all are here. Thank you. It's my claim to fame, Carly the Cute. Now I'm Cosmic Carly, so I'm a little bit more expansive. Pizza is here. Enjoy that pizza. Get it. pizza, 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 pizza. I know, the cat Winchester came in here. If all my followers, if y'all aren't following Kat, amazing streamer, absolutely gorgeous, also hilarious, also just a great gamer, and has an amazingly adorable dog, which we love dogs. Oh my gosh, so glad you just, thank you for rating me. I hope you have a great, hope you had a great rest of your stream. You're totally, your tab is totally open on my computer, and Ben, so now it's just like, oh, I love you guys. Thank you both so much. Thank you for the raids, so much love. Thank you for trusting your community to me. Hi, I'll turn this down. Just jamming out, cooking in the kitchen. She outright murdered some guys that had no idea what they were getting into. Yes. Oh my god. I love her. So funny to me. So funny. I've only been, honestly, I just started following Kat not too long ago, so I feel like I have, like, so much, I have so many streams to catch of you still. Please post pics of your dog. Oh my god, so many brownie points for pet pics. I have been looking at dogs nonstop. I want one. Oh, I'm so glad you're all here, you cutie pies. Okay, chicken's baking. Hey, Echo, set 20-minute timer, please. So we got that going. Our mashed potatoes are already ready, so we can add the sour cream over there. I should throw away these breadcrumbs, right? I should throw them away. Can I feed them to squirrels? Is there something else? I don't want to throw them away, really. Cosmic Carly, Cosmic Cookly, Skeldaroony. It's good. How are you, dear? Oh my goodness. Glad you're here. We are just baking. We're making some chicken. We're also making cookies. Oh my god, that was the real reason we started cooking, was because we wanted to make some delicious baked goods. Who did that? Not me. We made, I made the pumpkin chocolate chip cookies the other day. Pumpkin and chocolate chip. They were unbelievable. And then, buckeye cookies. So, normally I don't stream cooking. Like, usually I'm just kind of, streaming Qigong, which is this healing meditative practice. Slow breathing, slow stretching. Cookies and chicken, and I just got here. So down for this. Yeah. I was like, I don't eat a lot of meat. I usually make a lot of soups just because they're super easy. I can do them in the instant pot and just forget about them. Cook them while I'm working. Or like food that's already frozen that I can just throw in a skillet and make. Like, I do easy things most of the time. So I'm like, okay, we're doing a big meal. Let's stream it. Let's do it. So funny. I can't believe everything I had was expired. So silly. But yeah, this chicken's gonna be so good. Oh my god, my soup. I love soups too. I've been, actually, if you go on my Discord, I've got like a whole section of healthy food and recipes. So like, if you guys want to share what you're making, if you've got cool recipes to share, I've been making broccoli cheddar carrot soup nonstop. That's why I have all this like random cheddar in my house. But this is what we're making right now, so this is what it's supposed to look like. We don't have carrots, so sorry carrots, no carrots today. But we do have mashed potatoes and chicken, so I'm gonna do my two favorite parts of this meal. Drop the Discord! Oh shoot, I should have that. Let me see. I should have that link. I got this somewhere. Here's my Discord. And can I copy this link? Just gonna take me there, but I bet I can. Let me see if I can copy this paste. Share that invite link. Copy link. Let's see if I can figure this out. Hey, look at my crazy hair today, y'all. It's gonna look so cute when I take it down from this, though. Okay, chat. Man, I cannot believe how many followers we're at. I just found out Twitch existed in April, so I'm like brand new to everything. I have no idea even like what I'm doing half the time. It's also in my about But here, I think I got the invite. Yeah, you should be able to click that. You like the messy bun. This is, usually it is some kind of a messy bun, but this is like, if I take it down, I actually curled all my hair, which is crazy. There you go. You got it. So, I'm going to add sour cream to the mashed potatoes. I just bought new oven mitts because I've just had like crappy cheap oven mitts forever. These were actually not expensive either, but they're nice ones. Straining the potatoes. Sorry, another loud one. Oh my gosh, wow. I don't know if I'm hot from the oven or just like flushed from the raids, but thank you guys for coming in here and for hanging out. Like, Kat, thank you for bringing your community here. I started saying this and then I got all ADHD brain distracting myself. But yeah, normally I do Qigong, which is just like slow stretching. Breathing and stretching, it's a martial art, so like Tai Chi, but it actually like helps bring healing energy through our body. So it helps with anxiety and depression, like not sleeping well, like all sorts of things. So fix my boobs there. My bra was sticking out, so rather my cleavage than my bra. Let's be real. Sitting on my computer, eating Twix bar and a date bar. Honestly, where is my... Sometimes this is my dinner. Like, I do not judge, alright? Like, sometimes I eat a whole chocolate bar from Aldi and that's my dinner. Like, and I'm just like, I don't feel like cooking. Like, today this is what we're doing because this is what I have the spoons for, you know? Like, whatever it might be. So, sometimes it be like that. The bob's sitting nice. Y'all like in this bird's nest up here? Look at this little bow. Oh, I didn't salt or pepper that chicken either. Seriously helps with the stiffness from arthritis and tendonitis. Have you been doing it? Yes. Yes, we do this one for arthritis especially. And this one I think really helps. So we're breathing in, and as we breathe out, we're pushing our hand on the other arm. So breathing in, we're collecting all this good energy, good chi, and then we're pushing it down our hand. So it's helping clear our mind, helping bring clear energy to our mind, helping stretch our shoulders and our arms, especially if you sit at the computer a lot. A lot of us hunch over. Bad posture is totally rampant in gamers. Like, we can't even deny, I can't deny it. I have the worst posture. I call it the Leverkham lean. This is how my whole family stands, and they're all tall as heck, so they lean over and I'm like, oh, see, y'all are short like me. That's why I stand up so tall. You know, boobs. Bubbos. Those good old bubbos. I've been doing more leg-focused stuff, but general exercises as well. Well, and my favorite ones are the leg exercises. So, like, if we do that wide-legged one where we're sitting wide-legged and then we're breathing in and breathing out, we're flowing down our legs with, like, the arms that... Let me think about this. I'm like, hang on, can y'all see me down here? Probably not. Here, well, I have carpet in here, so whatever. So you do wide-legged, and then we hold the leg with our dominant, the hand for this leg, and then we're breathing and pushing down. Breathing in, and breathing out. Ooh, healer. some qigong while we cook.
This is normal.
Same thing on the other side. Hold your right leg with your right hand. Breathing in, breathing out as you push down. This is a great one for like your neck and shoulders. Is it breathing out as we bring our chin down to our chest, and then breathing in as we stretch our heads up. I don't know if you guys can hear me that well.
Qigong cooking stream, exactly, Spirit. I was like, we can do Qigong and cook at the same time. That's fine. Bye, baby Blue Jay. Great to meet you. Thank you for being here. Hope to see you again soon. We usually do morning Eastern time streams, so usually about 9:30 or 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. So if you ever come back, or if you ever just want to watch the VODs, I'll try to get some highlights of just the practices. Just try to make it shorter so that it's more accessible to more people. So love you. Big love. If you're on Instagram, follow me on Instagram. That's a great way to connect with me and see other random parts of my life. Behind the scenes stuff. And then feel free to message me anywhere, jump in the Discord. It's so great to meet you. Like, big love. My whole goal for streaming was just like connect with more people, help people if they have chronic pain, stress, anxiety, depression, PTSD, if they want to, you know, lose weight, if they want to get healthier, feel better. Like, I've lived with chronic pain, being overweight my whole life, feeling really, really low self-esteem, really feeling not good enough. Like, that was my whole mentality, was I'm never going to be good enough. I'm not worthy of good things. Like, just kind of in this really dark place. So my whole idea was like, I pulled myself out of it, and Qigong helped me do that. So I'm like, if I can even share this with just a few people that this can help, like, that's what it's all about. So if you have people who have chronic pain, chronic illness, stress, anxiety, share it with whoever might need it. Oh yeah, that stream was so great, Skeld. You would have loved the whole thing. It was great to listen to, just to hear two perspectives, similar perspectives, but still like just that, the back and forth, you guys building off each other. It was a really, really great to listen to. Great stream. Odin's Eye Tarot, if you guys don't know who we're talking about. We're big into the tarot community, and personally I love the ASMR community, which I know that there's a lot of weirdness in that area, but there's a lot of wholesomeness too, of people who are trying to help people heal, so through soothing and calming noises. So so amazing. So I forgot what I was doing already. We are making mashed potatoes, y'all. I don't remember this song, but I do really like it. I didn't know a thing about it before joining you the other day. I assure you, you have reached one person with it, and it has helped me so much. Thank you very much. You are an amazing person. I don't ever doubt it, because if you do, I'll rally the troops and we'll kick your butt with love. Oh my god, you're such a genuine soul, Skeld. I'm so grateful for you. I like the Qigong stream. She'll just look up at the cam with random smiles, because it seriously makes me so happy. Like,
doing those moves, like, afterwards, I just sit there and bask in it. Like, after the stream's over, you guys, I, like, feel like I can actually have a productive work day and, like, enjoy it and not just be, like, miserable and in pain. And I get stuck at a computer for 10.5 hour days after that. So it's, like, I need to do something to make my body feel good, or I just, like, I'm just, like, uncomfortable and pain. My neck hurts, my shoulders, my, you know, lower back especially. So I love it because it's, I can feel us doing something. I loved yoga. I've been doing yoga since I was a kid, but I never felt that instant relief from yoga. Yoga was more of a building muscle, and then as you get better at it, it feels better. Different moves feel better, but Qigong, it's like every move has an intended purpose. Every pressure point is doing its intended purpose, right? So, and it's like, hey, if I can hold my wrist right here, in the center of my wrist on the crease, and my anxiety goes away, and you're telling me we're not teaching this to parents and teachers and kids who need it? Like, how many kids have anxiety and you're just like, you just make them sit through class all day? Or even worse, you make them go up in front of the class and give a presentation, like, you know, like, oh, hey, instead, how about we, like, you know, you can give your presentation from your desk, and if you hold your pressure points, then you can get through your presentation a little easier. Every time you get nervous, just put a little pressure on that pressure point. And they're like, oh, that does make me feel so much better. It's like, yeah, dude, there's a lot of things we can do to help people. Anxiety is up but under control. So there you go, anxiety. Oh my god, that's, I didn't even read that. I was up in chat a little bit. Thank you for sharing that link. I appreciate that. That's one way to shout out people. Exactly. Just the twitch.tv and then their link. Oh, heck. No, because trigonometry is way more useful in adult life. I use Pythagorean theorem all the time instead of doing taxes. Yeah. Schools, man, right? Schools. I can give a pretty good back massage, I've heard. So I'm on my way. Oh, good. Oats. You are being requested. That's my job. Oh yeah, Anon is my Twitch boyfriend. It was voted on in chat. Not my chat, but another chat we were in. Oh my gosh. Yeah, how... I know, the school system. What is causing the anxiety? Great question. Today has been a test of facing the harsh truth of the anger rising. I got upset this morning when Derek came to pick up Elin, and not like mad or upset, but just kind of like, I just started crying randomly and was just feeling like hurt because I asked if I could help him with something and he was like, no, I'm fine. And I took that personally as, oh, he doesn't need my help anymore. Like, I'm no longer needed. And I took it personally as like, as a caretaker type personality, where that's how I feel good, is if I'm helping people or like fulfilling a need, right? And so he was like, hey, I'm really sorry, like, I didn't mean to reject you, like, he was like, I have a kink in my neck, and I'm like, oh, do you want me to like give you a quick massage, like, do you need like literally some knuckles grounded on the back of your neck? And he was like, no, I'm fine, like, I don't need your, because I have cold hands. Like, you want some ice hands? He's like, no. And I was just like, oh, you know, I just took it personally. And it was me having to recognize, like, I don't always have to be the caretaker. Like, that's not where my value doesn't lie in my ability to caretake. You know, my value lies in who I am as a person, like, all the good things I do. So it was kind of that, he apologized. I was like, you don't have to apologize. Like, that was a lesson I needed to learn, and just recognizing, like, oh, I don't have to get upset about that. Like, that's just me taking something that you felt personally. And he was like, thank you. So, it was good. It was a good lesson. Sometimes you just gotta learn a little bit. You're gonna steal all the chimkin? Don't steal the chicken. Oh, blue mega banana. What did I miss? Who's in here? Do we have a new friend? Oh yeah, I used Pythagoras' theorem to prove a statement I made about the size of displays. That's hilarious. Legit. Interesting to me. Wait. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. And sometimes, like, it's like, just... because it's like, you know, him and I are just friends at this point, and... so I'm like, I need to recognize, like, the things you say don't have to impact me that much. I don't have to get all, like, heard about things. And so I just, you know, when I started getting a little, like, choked up, and I recognized that in myself, and I got up, and I walked away, and I took my vitamins, my stress relief vitamin, and, like, my anti-anxiety med, and it reminded me, like, oh, yeah, I haven't taken my mood stabilizer yet for the day, so, and taken all my other vitamins, so it was kind of just, you know, a good reminder, drank some water, drank my smoothie. It was just like, you know, my body was just getting a little out of whack, and I, you know, my emotions showed me that I wasn't taking care of my body. So it just kind of was that reminder of, oh yeah, I just needed to take care of me for a second. So I got up, walked away, did that. He's like, hey, can we keep talking? I'm like, yeah, I'll be right back. So new perspectives, new shifts. You know, a few of the members, but there's something like 16 aunties and uncles that meet. What? I'm trying to find the humor in this, because it's like, really, get over yourself. What are we talking about? I must have missed something about the... Oh, that's right, Scalderoni was talking about the anxiety. My first official family outing with my better half is tomorrow, and unfortunately it's a funeral. Oh, that is stressful. Aw, yikes. Yeah, that is stressful. Sorry, I totally missed that part of it. I was like, I must have missed something. Thank you. Yeah, that is stressful. Ooh. Echo, stop. Thank you. Sorry, that's a great song, but it reminds me of my ex so hard. I was like, oh yeah, I forgot about that line. We gotta skip this one for now. Check me out! She's such an amazing streamer. Yes, agreed. Yay, with consent, of course. Yeah, that's definitely stressful. Speaking of water, hydrate, beanhead. Oh, thank you. Where's my water? Look at my hair is coming down, y'all. It's like, I'm done. I'm done being in the spun. Delicious. Thank you. Great, great suggestion. This song is so good.
No Borders by Malika Zara.
This is one that I want to put in Artie's music channel for sure. I have no idea what language this is either. It's so beautiful though. Look at how yummy that turned out. It's pretty tasty. I do feel like, I don't know. For some reason I feel like it needs more time. I don't know why. It felt like that went really fast. Let's get it up. ready to go, ready to be eaten. Oh my goodness, yum, that looks good. Did they both cook that well? Holy cow. Wow, dang, they look perfect. I kind of want to put it in for just a minute longer though, for some reason. I don't know why I always want to do that. Don't touch it, Kylie. Don't touch it, it's still hot. My somewhat preemptive defense, though, it is with Manuka honey. Ooh, Manuka honey. Love it. All about it. Echo, set 5-minute timer, please.
5 minutes, starting now.
Thank you. This is my Manuka honey. Always gotta buy it on sale. This was on sale for $31 for, but this has lasted me a long time. Good place for a dream, but a dream away. Mashed potato masher from the antique store with the actual wooden handle. I love these. They're so solid. Regular old coffee with milk.
It's a good day for a sinner.
Good day for a sinner. Clean slate. Ooh. Why wait for a clean slate, baby?
Caught up, never meant to be. It's the curse of being free. Curse of being free. It's a good day for the travelers and the sinners. All will be winners. Every day begin againers.
The guitar in the song. Oh, bye, Anon. Thanks for being here so long. You are such a gem. Oh, is Artie on? Shoot. Is Artie streaming tonight? Shoot. That was so fun last night. Watching me wrestle, I was losing my shit. Literally losing it. It was so much fun. Yeah, he just went live. Oh, I knew it. Raina! Hi, cutie pie! Hi, beautiful! Oh my god, Raina, everyone. Raina the queer. So glad to see you. What a blessing you are. Glad to have you here. Oh, what a great being you are. How's your day going?
Oh. For the travelers and the sinners, all will be winners. The everyday begin again.
So cozy, right? Yes, if y'all are not following Raina and you missed the amazing raid we did over there, please give Raina a follow. Click on that name, click on follow. Seriously, it was so much fun being in your stream. I legitimately forgot that I had a job interview and missed my job interview because I was having so much fun hanging out with you. I forgot the time. I was like, oh no. It's like, oh no. I just emailed them though. Oh, I don't think they got back to me yet, hopefully. Yep, I totally forgot about that. I was supposed to be checking my email to see if they were getting back to me. Oh, I was like, oh no, what is wrong with me? Carly and Nett. I've never forgotten an interview. I've never forgotten an interview ever. Yeah, exactly. But I had to go pick up my son, so I was thinking about that.
Oh, sweet. They just sent me, they just sent me an interview, or, like, a schedule to schedule another interview. I'll be out next week, but I sent you a new invite to reschedule. Hopefully we're able to connect then. She's so nice. And one of my coworkers that I trained in with recommended me for the job, so. Oh my gosh. What do we got going on here? Never mind, this source is 1080p only, and this weather's after internet. Oh no, snap. Yikes, well I'm glad you're here with us. Oh, this is my friend's band. This song is amazing. They're from Kalamazoo, Michigan. Last Gasp Collective. All right, y'all. The literally some of the greatest musicians in this area. Echo, stop. Thank you. That's good. I'm a hero left like it's Congress. Pawn off my father's watches. Half of what you got. What do I see? Brown-skinned man, gun up for police. Later proven innocent. God damn! Oh, some real shit in these lyrics. Some real shit in these lyrics. You're refollowing me. Two shakes of a rattlesnake's tail. Take your time. Ermengarde. I know, it'll be fine though. Look at, they were like, we love you, you're gonna be fine. That was such a good stream this morning, Kata. I loved it. Set it off right. Oh, girl. Middle fingers to every oppressor. Hope I'm giving you a bad impression. Oh, love this song so much. So these are my friends from Kalamazoo. In Grand Rapids, an amazing group of people, musicians, singers, rappers, artists, all around unbelievable beings, who are like literally real ass music with real lyrics that's like, hey, we're making change in this world. And it starts with us. And I was like, mm-hmm. Green Fang, how's it going? Glad to see you all here. I can't believe we're up to like 30 people. This is wild, y'all. Thank you for your time today. So we just made some chicken, we just made some mashed potatoes, and we made cookies too. We gotta make those cookies, y'all. So what I realized I should have done was, I should have done layers of those peanut butter balls. But I didn't think of that until right now. Or, what to do. Thank you.
just what to do. Sorry, I'm getting distracted over there. Look at this. I need another clip. And I don't know just what to do. So you don't want me. Look at that. Little ringlet there. Okay. Just vibing out. Animal Crossings. What? Who's playing Animal Crossings? What did I miss? WTCG Gaming. Hello. Welcome in. Sang it, girl. Oh, nice, nice. Mashed taters. How you doing? Yum. Hopefully you're all well. I think I missed a bunch of chat, but hi. Cookie dancy, sing-songy, stretchy stream. Yeah, super random. Would I ever quit my job just to be the owner of a restaurant? I wouldn't quit my job to do it, because I have run a restaurant that was just starting off before, and I'd rather have the income and do it as a side job to start, and then see how it goes from there, and build it, essentially. I think that's probably the better way to do it. Alright, I think I'm gonna finish the rest of those cookies after I eat my dinner. Oh, I didn't put any butter in the mashed potatoes. That's not like me. At all. I love this one too. This is in my Love Yourself First playlist. Because I feel like loving yourself first shouldn't be all love and light. It should also be, hey, I'm sensitive. This is who I am. I'm an artist. And I used to want to change that, but now it's part of who I am, and I love that about myself. Is this TikTok? Echo.
Who's this by? Oh, shoot, it is. Yeah. Dang.
Here's something I found on the web. According to Wikipedia.org.
Echo. Just stop. Just play my music.
Here's a station based.
Echo. No. Stop. Go back to Spotify, please. Echo. Play my Love Yourself First playlist, please.
Love Yourself First from Spotify.
She was like, what? I'm so confused. Now you're confusing me even more. And now I'm going to just play random music based on your music. And I'm like, well, don't you do that. Love and relationships. This is a great song. Landreau, everyone. I gotta put some salt and pepper on these babies too. What can you do in angel's eyes? Because they make you forget about everything that has ever hurt you and the pain inside. And smile as bright as the sunshine, even though it may rain at times. Love is sacred and love is sanctified. It is what brought peace to the world in ancient times. Love is the same energy that created the universe and paints the sky. Love is the reason the birds sing at night and angels fly. Love is intellectual conversations that make our brains collide. Love can really make you go insane at times. Love is that little thing inside that makes anger die. Love told me to love myself, and then I became sublime. Love really can't be explained at times. Love is everything that I can't describe. Love is everything. Everything is love. Temple. Sunrise. Have you ever seen the sunrise? The moon jealous when the sun dies, and your mouth and mind get tongue-tied trying to express the feelings within your confines. And all of these things combine sometimes to make the things inside unwind. You give meaning to the sunrise and the reason that the sun shines. My sunrise. I knew you'd be the most beautiful flower this world has ever seen. My only wish indeed is to water your seeds until you grew larger than anyone could ever dream. Always encouraging you to love yourself and increase your self-esteem. Yeah, exactly. Love yourself. Love who you are. Doesn't mean love only certain parts. We're all fierce. But we all have our melting into putty moments as well. Gotta love the mama bear and the melty putty. Yeah, exactly. Food looks nice. Oh, thank you. Aw. Yes. I love you all very much. It is with you that I choose to share my sublime feelings. You are what the universe is made of. Beautiful divine women. Though your skin is like silk compared to fine linen, it is the ocean of your soul that divides linen. A big old pile of mashed potatoes and some delicious, crispy, crunchy, buttery chicken. You make angels bless in your presence. You are such a precious
I think I found heaven tonight. So many stars in the sky, oh my, but you are like the brightest one. You possess enough power in your smile to light the sun. You are divine, the righteous one. Stop waiting for Christ to come. My goddess. This is my song to myself. Every time I listen to this, I'm like, I found you and I came alive.
Sunset.
My goddess.
From my perception, it seems like everything in life is
I am my own goddess.
I want to know everything about you except what you do for money. Living in a generation that bases its relations off compensation.
There's never 100% of everything. I'm very hungry. Well, do you have potatoes? You can make a whole meal with just potatoes. I'm super excited for this. Salt, pepper, the peanut butter is freezing.
the only star that would shine as the night.
I think that's everything, really. I think I'm gonna sit and eat. I think we're gonna raid over to my dear, dear friend, Cosmic Unwind, who has helped me. I've been streaming for a while now. What, four hours? 3 hours? Toss it through the screen like one potato, I'll catch it. Okay, ready? I'll throw the biggest potato I have. You ready? Bye, WTC Gaming. To you. Bye. If you want to stick around for the raid, you get extra channel points. My stepbrother is a musician. He has a CD. That's so cool. Green Fang. I'm going to be big and strong. Enjoy the food. Thank you. Yeah, we've been streaming a minute, but we're going to raid over to the person who's helped me mentally more than even my own therapist. This is just like a stream of unconditional love. Give him a follow. Help just elevate yourself to that next level. Remind yourself that you are worthy, that you are loved. 3:33, here we go. We're going at the right time. Super excited to see him. This is my mod for him, Soda Spirit. A lot of the people who are in here tonight mod for him. So super grateful for all of you for being here, for spending time with me, for everything, for the, good number. I was born 3/3/93 at 3:10 p.m. So all about the threes. Much love. Thanks for sticking around. I appreciate that. Hopefully you love him as much as I do. He's just been such a great presence in my life, keeping me on my right path of loving myself and taking the next steps forward. I love this streamer too. This is my guy. 1 out of 10 for you. Hopefully you mean 10 out of 10. Much love. Thank you for the stream. You're a snack. Odie, making me blush on stream. Thank you. Here, you guys gotta see my hair before we go. Because it's so cute. And we'll stream tomorrow morning too. Oh no. Y'all are gonna see my hair all tangled up instead of all cute. It still looks pretty cute. Love you guys so much. Like, so much love. You're all amazing. You're all such blessings. Still looks pretty good. Much love. Bye. Have a great day. Thanks for joining me. Thank you for your time. Big love.